Greetings! Greetings, noble guests! I, Caesar, along with the enchantingly beautiful Cleopatra, bid you welcome to the magnificent Roman Empire of Caesar's Palace. We are most pleased you have joined us in this glorious evening as we celebrate our partnership with the illustrious Jockey and Jeans charity, which is dedicated to aiding the Permanently Disabled Jockeys Fund. Tonight, our chefs have prepared Epicurean delights for your enjoyment. Noble guests, enjoy, and may the gods of great fortune smile upon you and spread riches to the Jockeys and Jeans through your foundation. Donations. And now please, welcome your MC for tonight's festivities, Racing Rachel McLaughlin.
I think I'd be used to bright lights, but those are really bright. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Jockeys and Jeans. How's everybody doing? I am so excited to be here. I've been to a couple events of these events before, and when I got asked to MC, I was jumping at the opportunity to be here and a part of the evening. It's such a wonderful cause, so thank you everyone for being a part of the evening. Jockeys and Jeans was founded by a group of former jockeys who not only wanted to publicize the inherent dangers of race riding, but also to honor courage those who also have suffered catastrophic injuries on the racetrack. Their motto is, "We are the lucky ones. We walked away intact, but we will never forget our brothers and sisters who did not. In the blink of an eye, the lives of these jockeys and those around them can change forever." We're so happy that you're here tonight. It takes a special form of bravery to sit atop an 1,100-pound racehorse running at 40 miles per hour, and it takes even more courage to rise above the challenge of catastrophic injury that these men and women face every day. And obviously, we're here to raise money for these wonderful athletes, so we ask the entire racing industry, including our fans and everyone here of our great sport, to support our injured riders, and your generosity tonight makes a difference. So remember to get out your phones, and you can log in to, you don't have to go outside, which is really nice. Technology, guys. There's a QR code, if anyone didn't get it, to log in and be able to put your money in and bid on some of the wonderful items outside. So without further ado, we will get everything started. And we're going to first ask up Jamie LaRocca, is joined Jockeys and Jeans as a committee member in 2017, working as a liaison with fallen riders. His injury occurred on December 3rd, 1982, as a 20-year-old apprentice. Jamie and his family reside in Kansas City, Kansas. Please welcome up Jamie LaRocca, please.
Thank you, Rachel. Thank you, everybody, for coming here, and thank you for your support. It's my privilege to introduce the honorees for tonight's event. Our first honoree is Roger Blanco. Roger was injured on June 23rd, 1988. He joined Jockeys and Jeans as a committee member in 2021, and he also works with the Fallen Riders along with me. It's always great seeing Roger at these events. Our next honoree is Gary Berzer. Gary was injured on July 20th, 2004. He rode mainly at Mountaineer Park when they were started racing year-round. He's been a big part of the PDJF family, and I'm so glad he's with us this year. Next is Stacy Burton. Stacy was injured on August 26, 2000. Since her accident, she continues to have her humor, intelligence, and devotion to doing her own therapy. It's always fun having Stacy here at these events. Next is Dennis Collins. Dennis was injured on September 25th, 2016. He rode for 30 years before he was injured. He wasn't able to make it to the event last year, and we're so happy that he's with us this year. Our next honoree is Jack Fires. Jack was injured on May 17th, 1977. He is a PDGF board member, and his brother is retired Hall of Fame rider Early Fires. Welcome, Jack. Our next honoree is Joe Ellen Hayes. Joe was injured on November 28th, 1997. She continues to ride pony horses when she can, and I'm so glad I was able to meet her at this event this year. Welcome. Our next honoree is Michael Martinez. Michael was injured on September 12th, 2010. He was one of the most talented riders on the Northern California circuit. It's so nice seeing him, and his cousin is a retired Hall of Fame rider, Alex Solis. Our next honoree is Armando Rivera. Armando was injured on July 10th, 1979. He really does a lot to raise awareness for the PDJF and Jockeys and Jeans when he's racing in marathon events. And Armando is also a Jockeys and Jeans ambassador. Next is Michael Strait. Mike was injured on August 26, 2009. He uses the exoskeleton suit to aid in his walking, and he's logged almost a 500,000 steps. It's great having him with us here tonight. Next is Ann Von Rosen. Ann was injured on March 11, 2014. She recently moved to Ocala to focus on her physical therapy and to get back into the thoroughbred business. I'm glad she's with us. Welcome, Ann. And please put your hands together once again for our honorees for this year's event.
I'm not interrupting anyone's pictures. Hey, Armando. I love Armando. He came and visited me. I didn't even tell you guys, if those of you that don't know, I'm the horse racing analyst at Horseshoe Indianapolis. And Armando came last year, and he hung out with me and George Leonard, who trains at Horseshoe Indianapolis. And when they say he's a great, you're all great ambassadors, but he did come visit me, so that's why he got the special nod. Next, I'm going to introduce Hall of Fame jockey coordinator Sandy Hawley, another wonderful person who's been talking to me and helping me the last couple of days. He was inducted into the U.S. Racing Hall of Fame in 1992. In 1973, Hawley broke Bill Shoemaker's record when he became the first jockey to win over 500 races in a single season. In 76, Sandy won an Eclipse Award as Outstanding Jockey and was twice named Canada's Athlete of the Year. Please welcome Sandy Hawley to the stage.
Thank you, everyone. Rachel, you said that just the way I wrote it. Thank you very much. It's my pleasure to introduce the Hall of Fame jockeys. I guess it's appropriate. I chase them around all my career. And ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to introduce them for the year that they were inducted into the Hall of Fame. So that's the order I'm going to do it. And first, you know what? I was looking for something for this guy, and I was looking all over the internet, and I'm going, who is this Lafitte Pinkai guy? He only received 5 Eclipse Awards as leading money-winning jockey, and 7 times he was the leading money-winning jockey as well. In 1984, Lafitte won the Kentucky Derby on Swale, and Pinkai broke Bill Shoemaker's record of 8,834 wins and ended his career with 9,530 wins. Lafitte Pinkai. These guys are all my good friends, but another good friend who was inducted in 1990 is George Velasquez. Velasquez rode great horses such as Chris Evert, Devon DeVale, and in 1981, George won the Kentucky Derby on Pleasant Colony, and he considered his best mount was Alidar. George Velasquez. Next, I have to introduce this guy as Mr. Pat Day. He was better known as Payday. He started his career as a rodeo rider, but I think he picked the right career. Pat Day was 4-time Eclipse Award-winning jockey. Pat won 12 Breeders' Cup races and won 9 Triple Crown races, including the Kentucky Derby on Little E2 in 1992. Pat Day. Next is a jockey that once he got on the lead, I could never catch this guy. Early Fires. He was inducted in 2001. Early is an Arlington Parts all-time winningest rider. Fires won 7 races twice at Arlington Park. Early won racing titles in 4 different decades. That is a testimony to longevity for sure. Early Fires. Next, ladies and gentlemen, he actually is our oldest living Hall of Fame rider, Mr. Bill Boland, inducted in 2006. This part is amazing. In 1950, Boland won the Kentucky Oaks aboard Arps Mona. The following day, he rode Middle Ground to victory in the Kentucky Derby at 16 years old. In 1959, Boland received the prestigious George Wolfe Award at Santa Anita Racetrack, the great Bill Boland. Another great rider, he was inducted in 2007, Jose Santos. Santos was North America's leading rider for earnings 4 consecutive years, from 1986 through 1989. Jose won 7 Breeders' Cup races, including the classic aboard Val Pony at odds at 43-1. I wish I had a bet on that one. In 2003, Jose won the Kentucky Derby and the Preakness aboard Funny Side. Jose Santos. Next, ladies and gentlemen, is another Hall of Famer. His name is Edgar Prado. He was inducted in 2008. In 1997, Edgar won 536 races. I thought I did good when I won 515. But he was the 4th rider in history to win over 500 races in a single season. Prado won 2 Belmonts and had 5 Breeders' Cup victories. In 2006, Edgar rode Barbaro to victory in 132nd Kentucky Derby. Edgar Prado. And the next guy is a guy that never gave me any strokes on the golf course, and his name is Don Pierce. He was inducted in 2010, and during Don's career, he was known as a money rider. In 1973, Pierce led all North American jockeys with 32 stakes wins. Don rode some of the best horses of his time, Ack Ack, Kennedy Road, Quack, and Kelso. Ladies and gentlemen, Don Pierce. The next Hall of Famer was inducted in 2014, Alex Solis. Solis and Snow Chief won 8 graded stakes together. 5 of those were grade ones, including the Preakness. Alex had 3 Breeders' Cup victories and was given the nickname El Maestro, meaning the Little Master, Alex Solis. Next is a guy, when we were young, they used to get us mixed up all the time. They used to call me Daryl, and they used to call him Sandy. Daryl McCarg. He was inducted in 2020. And in 1978, Daryl received an Eclipse Award as Outstanding Jockey. McCarg rode such outstanding horses as Ancient Title, John Henry, My Juliet, and Vigors. Daryl is now the Chief Steward of the California Horse Racing Board. Ladies and gentlemen, Daryl McCarg. And actually, a new inductee to the Hall of Fame this year, in 2023, is going to be Corey Nakatani. Corey won 341 graded stakes, including 10 Breeders' Cup races, 4 of those being the Breeders' Cup Sprint. Corey won 3 riding titles at Del Mar, 2 at Santa Anita, 1 at Hollywood Park, as well as 4 at Oak Tree Meetings. Ladies and gentlemen, Corey Nakatani. And last but not least, I would like to introduce a Hall of Fame quarter horse rider, J.R. Carter. This guy has an amazing, amazing resume. J.R. Carter leads all quarter horse riders in wins and money won. J.R. won the prestigious Grade 1 All-American Futurity twice at Ruidoso Downs. And he mentioned to me, too, that he won, it's equivalent to the Eclipse Award in quarter horse racing, 9 times. Ladies and gentlemen, J.R. Carter. And you know what? Back in my day, there was like the great Avelino Gomez. He used to do the peace sign. He used to jump straight in the air and land like a graceful athlete. Avelino did it. Frankie Dettori did it. Angel Cordero did it. But I think we have a shot of JR with his dismount. Do we have that shot? How about that one? Not too bad, JR. Ladies and gentlemen, these are your Hall of Fame jockeys for the evening. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, now we are going to welcome up our CEO of Caesars Entertainment, Tom Reeg, to the stage to do an official welcome. Tom?
Rachel's right, it is bright up here. I do want to add my welcome to Caesar's Palace. I had the pleasure of meeting a lot of you last night and heard about how this started in Tampa 9 years ago in the rain outside. So you guys have come a long way. We are proud to host this event. It's striking to me to see those that reach the pinnacle of the sport as athletes give back to those that weren't as fortunate. This is really, really a cool event. So at Caesars, we own and operate 4 racetracks. Right now, we're building a 5th in Nebraska as we speak. My personal connection to racing is I grew up in Arlington Heights, Illinois, about a mile and a half from Arlington Park. And what I learned about racing when I was a teenager was if I skipped my last class and made a couple bets on Early Fires or Pat Day, I could buy the beer that weekend. So what we want to do is kick this off. Where's Barry? We want to kick this off with our donation. We're proud to donate $30,000 to
there. Let me tell you something. Caesars Entertainment with Tom, a good friend, Don, Lynette, and the whole crew here has gone beyond the pale. Can you believe what we had out there? You wait till you see what we have in here. They believe in all these folks up here. They committed to making their lives better. And do we appreciate this?
Amen.
Now, people always say to me, what's it like to be a fallen rider? And I say, folks, it's very simple to figure out. I want you all to put your hands on your lap. Ready? I want you now to raise your feet off the ground. Stand up. That's what it's like to be a fallen rider. So, Tom, we have something for you. This is the first time we've done anything this serious. This is a Hall of Fame boot to Tom Regg and Caesars Entertainment from Jockeys and Jeans in the PDGF. I'm going to get in the picture, will you? It's like my big brother. You made my day. So, let's give a big round of applause to Tom, Caesars, our Hall of Famers, and our fallen riders for going the extra mile. Thank you so much. I'm taking this with me.
Here. Why didn't you use this? We do want to remind you guys to please be sure to bid on the silent auction items. They are available until about 9:15, so you've got a little while, but please get out your phones. And if you haven't already, there are QR codes in the frame pictures out there, so be sure to remember that we are raising money for these wonderful people, this wonderful cause, and to be open with your wallets, maybe. We do have that going until 9:15, and next I would like to introduce another person to the stage. This is actually the vice president of Jockeys and Jeans. I didn't do it, I swear. Ed Donnelly, please give him a round of applause.
I'm here for one purpose, and it's not me. It's above and beyond me. You've heard the movie The Good, The Bad, and The Ugly. Well, I'm going to introduce you to the good, because I was the bad and the ugly. I'm going to introduce you to a legend in his own time. He is the only jockey in history to have his own statue and also be on the racing commission and have a graded stakes race named after him, the Pat Day Stakes. Pat, come on up. I love my brother. He's actually the same height as me. That's a lovely thing. But Pat was with us at the very start, and Mr. Riggs spoke of that, and we started in an outdoor, open, basically picnic table area, and our picnic tables were decorated with red and white checker cloths, and hence the name Jockeys and Jeans. And while so many of the Hall of Famers have sacrificed and put their lives on hold and even have overcome illness to come and to be with us, Pat is the only person that has been, and he and his wife Sheila, where's Sheila? Give Sheila a hand. What a wonderful lady. Despite health issues, she's been to every of the 9 events. That's the only person that I know of. And you know, thank you. I did before. We have a little something for Pat Day. This is our Uphill Push Award. It's awarded each year annually to the person who does the most to advance the cause for those riders you just saw. And Pat Day, I tell you, I walked around Keeneland with him from the select sales to induce people to give us seasons to donate. And I'm telling you, don't walk around with Pat Day unless you got a lot of time. Because he will stop and talk to a groom for 30 minutes. He doesn't care. He loves them all. Pat, this is your award.
I get to say something?
Yeah. I'm going to say something to you, too.
Well, you made a mistake. Give me the microphone. He just told you I'd talk for 30 minutes. I promise you I won't. I'm honored to receive this award. I'm so proud of Jockeys and Jeans and the work that they're doing to raise funds for our fallen comrades, for the Disabled Jockeys Fund, for the Permanently Disabled Jockeys Fund. And I'm honored to receive this award and certainly honored to be here tonight with my wife. And as Ed alluded to, she's overcome some difficulties just to be here with us. And so happy to be here with family and friends and celebrating our fallen comrades, raising funds for and awareness of this wonderful organization. So thank you. God bless.
Well, Pat, don't go away. We're going to have you pray. Pat has opened every one of our events with the invocation and a prayer. And as I said, we started at Tampa Bay Downs in an outdoor pavilion, and it rained so hard, people leaving had to wade through knee-deep water. And look where we are now. Is this moving on up or what? And you know, Pat has prayed for every event we've had. So Pat, keep on praying.
Well, would you all pray with me if you would, please? Oh, great and gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, how we love you, we thank you, we praise you, Father, for all that we have and all that we are. We recognize, Lord, that we are what we are by your grace. All that we have, we've received from your hand. And Father, we thank you for this evening. We thank you for Jockeys and Jeans and the work that they're doing to raise funds for the Permanently Disabled Jockeys Fund. But more importantly, Father, we pray for our fallen comrades and the difficulties that they face every day. Father, right now we just thank you for this event. We thank you for Caesars and their support and their sponsoring of this event tonight. We ask your continued blessings upon them. But we ask your blessings upon all that are in attendance here tonight, Lord, to be with them, to watch over them and protect them. Now, Father, we ask that you bless this food to our bodies and our bodies to your service. Continue with us. Bless us with a wonderful time this evening. We'll be sure to give you all the praise, the honor, and the glory. In Jesus' precious name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Yeah? How about a round of applause for the F&B staff who have done an amazing job this evening? It takes a lot for the F&B team to take care of such a big, rowdy group, so thank you guys so much. We'll see you as the chair falls over. I told you. I'm not only the host, but I think I also was brought here to keep the timing straight and to keep this man in line, which has been a pretty hard task. But we are going to now welcome our president of Jockeys and Jeans up to the stage. Give a round of applause for Barry Pearl.
Normally, when you come up to one of these things, you say, can everybody hear me? But I say, can you see me? Again, I want to give all you folks a big round of applause because you make this happen. It's absolutely wonderful. Every year at all our events, I put together a slideshow of some theme that I thought was cool. One year we did something with our junior jockeys of Flying Cross Ranch, which you'll meet later. One year we did something about how this thing all came about. But this year, special. This year, we have the honor of Mike and Gabby Strait, one of our fallen riders and his lovely wife, got married. And we are presenting to you the happy occasion of Mike and Gabby Strait.
I can think of younger days when living for my life was everything a man could want to do.
I could never see tomorrow, but I was never told about the sorrows.
How can you mend the broken laws?
How can you stop the rain from falling down?
It happened far from the grounds of Saratoga Racecourse, where Mike Strait grew up watching Hall of Fame riders such as Jose Santos and Chris McCarron ply their trade. Still, the impact of the catastrophic racing accident that sent the 24-year-old jockey into the emergency surgery Thursday reached far beyond the Arlington Park Oval in Chicago. The incident, which occurred when I'm No Gentleman collapsed and died at the back of a field of $10,000 maiden claimers. It left Strait with four fractured vertebrae and bleeding on the brain. Doctors at Lutheran General Hospital in Park Ridge, Illinois, initially feared severe head trauma or brain damage. Although that fear reportedly has subsided, Strait remains in critical condition Thursday evening as a team of specialists worked to repair the damage done to his spine.
Could never see tomorrow. No one said a word about the sorrow.
How can you mend a broken heart?
How can you stop the rain from falling down?
Stop the sun from shining. What makes the world go round?
And how can you mend this broken man? How can a loser ever win?
Mike to Gabby. I feel like everything in my life has led me to you. My choices, my heartbreaks, and my regrets. Everything. When we're together, my past seems worth it. If I had done one thing different, even the smallest of things, I may never have met you. This was God's plan.
You have the blessing of being a part of each other's achievements. You are now two halves of one soul. You are a team that rises and falls together. You have the blessing of holding on to each other, to being companion and warmth to each other, to being loving support to each other, and to being the hands that will always hold each other when there are no words to say. This marriage is truly blessed. Holy is this union and glorious is this wedding day. Beautiful is this marriage between Gabrielle and Michael. Those who have been joined together will be generously blessed forever. Now that you have chosen one another, honored each other with the precious gift of your rings, and vowed to love each other for all the days of your lives, bathe in your oneness. I bless you, my beautiful, beautiful young ones. To one another, I will love you forever. Say to one another together,
I will love you forever.
Now, with the power vested in me on this glorious afternoon of the 3rd of February in the year 2023, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may have your first kiss as a married couple.
Barry told me that he wanted to show everyone that there's a possibility of, not that there isn't, there definitely is, but of love and happiness after injury. So what a wonderful produced video by Barry Pearl. I'll have to add that to his resume. He's a producer now. A round of applause. Thank you guys so much. That was great. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I am going to introduce a man that I just literally met this morning, and he's made me laugh so many times today. He's really, really funny, and I'm not going to guarantee that you got the exact same jokes as I, because the mic isn't on, so I might have got the good ones. But that's not the best part about him, that he's funny, because everyone loves a funny guy. It's that he also knows about horse racing. When I heard him talking about pedigrees and ownership, I was like, well, you're just the perfect man. And that perfect man is Mark Klein.
Rachel, thank you very much. Now comes the fun part of our evening where you give us all your money. This is so fabulous. First of all, can we turn the house lights up? We're going to do an auction. I'm going to need to see bids and bid spotters. So I'm going to need the house lights turned up to a great extent. And while you all are figuring out the lights here, a couple things. There are two ways to do a charity auction. There's the easy way and the fun way. The easy way is somebody writes us a check for $500,000. They get all the stuff out in the hall, and we go hit the slot machines. That would be the easy way to do this. The fun way to do this is we actually auction off these fabulous live items. You've had a chance to look at them out in the hallway. They're just some fabulous, fabulous things. And to reiterate the benefit, the great athletes you saw up here, this wonderful cause benefits them. But for everyone that is up here, there are dozens and dozens that do benefit and will benefit from the funds that you provide here tonight. And so keep that in mind. You're doing this for many more people than we can fit on this stage. So we're going to get started now. Go ahead and turn the lights up even further. And if you can, they do not need to see my face. Turn the spotlights off or down if you can so that I can see beyond in the audience. Go ahead and kill our spots if you can, please. Just or turn them down. There we go. Things are coming up here now. And where are my bid spotters? Bid spotters, throw your hands up so I can see you. All right. Whoever, again, the spotlights, please. If you go ahead and turn the spotlights just off so I can see my bid spotters, because that'll make this a much easier task. I see one out there. You're going to have to really wave as we get these items underway. There we go. Thank you so much. Perfect. Okay. Excellent. All right. We have some just wonderful items here, and we're going to get started right now. Again, when you came in, Caesars, through the miracle of artificial intelligence, is able to rate exactly how much money you all can afford on a per-person basis. So we have some expectations of you, and we know you'll meet them, this being a racing crowd. So I've already placed a wager in the sports book at 4-1 that you'll exceed our goals for the evening. So let's get started with our first item up for bid. Our first item, this is a Woodford Reserve signed bottle of bourbon. It commemorates the 149th Kentucky Derby. That is Secretariat's 50th anniversary derby. You get this Woodford Reserve bottle. It's been signed by the 149th Kentucky Derby jockey, signed in silver. This is a limited edition. There's only three of these made. This is one of them. And along with the great signatures, you're allowed to drink the whiskey inside. So they have an estimated value on this of $150. And I'm telling you, what you'll do with that whiskey is worth far more than that. So our opening bid on this, I'd like an opening bid of $200. Oh, there's an opening bid of $200. I'll give you $200. I've got $200 here. I've got $200 there. Let's make it $500. Let's go to $500 and get this thing cranked up. $500, looking for an opening bid of $500. Looking for $500 opening bid. Do I have, if you're a bid spotter, put your hand up and wave until I've looked over to you. $500 here. I've got five. I've got 516. Got 516. Got 516. Got 500. 1600. I got 516. I got five. I got six right here. I got six. I see it over there. Got 600. 600. Looking for seven. Looking for seven. Do I have seven? Do I have seven? I've got seven. Looking for eight. I got seven. Looking for eight. Got seven. Looking for eight. Got 700. Got 700 made. 700 made. 700. Slow down. I have, you just bid $1,700 for some whiskey, sir. Congratulations. I think you'll be very happy. $700 is our bid. $700 for our Woodford Reserve whiskey. $700. Looking for eight. I have seven. Looking for 800. Want $800. I've got 700. Looking for eight. 700 going once.
Let me just say one quick thing. This has Ron Turcotte's signature on it. Ronnie Turcotte, we know, rode the greatest horse that probably ever lived, most people in racing consider, Secretariat. Ronnie Turcotte has given so much to horse racing, and he has signed this in person. This will carry his signature. You'll have a part of racing history for the rest of your life when you buy this.
So our current bid is $700. We're going to go for $800 on that. Got $700 bid. Got $700 bid. $700. I've got $800 over here. Got $800 bid. $800 looking for $900. Got eight want nine. Got $800. $800 looking for $900. Looking for $900. Got $800 over to my left. Looking for $900 on my right. Got $800 made over here. $800. $800. $800 going once. $800 going twice. Hammer down. $800. Thank you so very much, sir. $800. Our second item up for bid, a fun bit of racing and breeding history, a leather halter which was worn by the great stallion Quality Road. Quality Road sired 15 Grade 1 winners, and he's not done yet. He stands for $200,000 at Lane's End Farm, but you can own a piece of him with an opening bid of $500. So for $200,000, you get about 10 minutes of his time. For an opening bid of $500, you get this for the rest of your life. So let's begin this, a $500 opening bid, a halter worn by Quality Road, winner of 4 Grade 1 races. He won the Florida Derby and the Woodward and the Don Handicap. $500 opening bid, $500 bid, halter worn by Quality Road. Looking for an opening bid of $500. Looking for $500, won $500, $500 for the Quality Road. Got $500 over here. Got a bid of $500, looking for $6. Got $516, got $5, need $6. Got $500 bid over here, looking for $600, $600, $600. Got $500, looking for $600. The left-hand side of the room is doing great tonight. Nothing from the right. I've got $500 bid, looking for $6. I've got $6 back here. Thank you, sir. $600 bid, looking for $7. Got $617, got $617, got $600, looking for $700. Got $600 bid, looking for $700, $700, $700 over here, $700 over here. Got $600 bid here, looking for $7. I got $700 bid, looking for $7 on my left, looking for $7 on my right. Got $600 bid, $600 once, $600 twice. Hammer down, $600, halter from Quality Road. Our third item up for bid, this is a signed photograph of two Hall of Fame trainers. They don't need me to tell you who they are. Bob Baffert and Dwayne Lucas have signed this. They have fans around the world for their prowess in training, and whether you love them or feel otherwise, you can use this for whatever you wish for an opening bid of only $500. Bob Baffert and Dwayne Lucas sign this. You get Mr. Baffert and the coach together in one signed photograph, and they look great, and you'll look great with this on your wall. Want a $500 bid? Looking for $500. I got $500. Looking for $6. Got $516. Got $500. Looking for $600. I got $500 opening. Looking for $600. The opening bid is $5. Now I've got $6. Thank you, sir. Got $600. Looking for $7. Got $6 in this table. Looking for $700. Got $6. Looking for $7. $600 bid. Looking for $700. Got $6. Got $6, looking for $7, looking for $7, looking for $7, looking for $7, got $600, $600, looking for $700, got $600 made, looking for $7 to the left, looking for $700 to the right. I got $600 here, looking for one more bid at $700. Got $700, got $7, now it's a war, $700 and it's on for $8, $700, looking for $800. I got $700 bid, mailing for $800 bid, I got $7, $7, $7, $7, $7, looking for $8, $7, looking for $8, $8, $8, $8, $8, $8, $8, $8, got $700 bid, looking for $700. I've got $800 in the far left corner of the room, $800, thank you, sir. Your table's long overdue for a bid. Well done. $800 bid in that corner. $800 to the back of the room looking for $9. Got $800 looking for $900. Got $800 looking for $900. Got $800 looking for $9. Anything on their table here looking for $9. Got $800 back in here. What's that? Got that $1,000? $1,000 bid. Beautiful. $1,000 bid. Now we're at four figures. Let's go to $1,250. I got a bid for $1,000 looking for $12. Got $1,000 over $1,200. Got $1,000 looking for $1,250. $1,000 to $1,000. Bid at $1,000, $1,000. Got a grand made. Got a grand made looking for grand and $11. Got $1,000 looking for $11. $1,001, $11, $1,000 once, $1,000 twice, hammer down, $1,000, autographed picture, Baffert and Lucas. Oh, yeah, this is absolutely something that is one of a kind. There is no other. You can't get another, and Ed wants to have a word with you.
Yeah, this is an iconic piece of racing. Any of you that want to do what in racing is known as pin hooking, buying and selling, I know some people that have bought this fairly reasonable and have been offered a lot more money for it. There's only four of these left. You have signatures on here of people you will never get. This is right, people's in the Hall of Fame. For instance, Penny Chenery, who owns Secretariat, is on here. Jack Vanberg, Gary Jones, Leroy Jolly,
so many racing icons that the only way you're going to get their signatures, if you go to heaven, I hope they're there, because they have departed from this earth.
You might need two different tickets for that to get those signatures. So
there are only four of these left. We had 26. There's only four of them left. We sold one of these for $7,500. This was the going price. And I'm hoping this crowd here tonight is a little more generous than that crowd, because this is a very rare item.
From the National Museum Racing Hall of Fame, if you've heard of them, they've signed this poster. There's more names on here than we can possibly list, and every one of them is just worth having in your home. So we're going to start the bid on this at $2,500, opening bid, $2,500. I got $2,500 here, looking for three. Got $2,513, got $2,513. Now I've got three. Got $3,14, got $3,014, looking for $4,000. Got a $3,000 bid. Got three, looking for $3,500. Got $3,000, maybe looking for $35. Got three, looking for $35. Got $3,000 bid, looking for $3,500. The bid is $3,000, looking for $35. Ma'am, did you just scratch your ear or did you just buy a poster? I'm not sure which. Got $3,000 looking for $3,500. Got $3,000 looking for $3,500. $3,000 here looking for $35. $3,000 at $35. Looking for $35. $35. Got $3,000 made. One more time on this. The bid is $3,000, and the signatures on here, there's no price you can put on them. Some of these people are no longer with us. Some of these people, you'll never get a chance to do it again. Some of them didn't want to sign, but once Angel Cordero said he'd sign it, they all signed up. So
if you put this up on your wall or you put this up in your business, you don't have to worry about anybody else putting anything equal to this up. This is a rare piece. It's worth much more than the bid goes right now.
All right, we're at $3,000 buyer looking for $3,500. I got $3,000 looking for $3,005. I got $3,000 bid looking for $3,005, $3,500, $3,500, $3,250. I'll cut that a little bit. $3,250. Do I have a bid at that? The bid is $3,000. Want $3,250? The bid is $3,250. $3,250. $3,250 at $3,000. This could be the bargain of the century, certainly of page one. The bid's $3,000. I've got $3,250. Where's our bidder right there? $3,250? Did you mean $3,500? You may have meant $35. He did mean $35. A sport and a half. The bid's $3,500. Looking for $3,750. The bid's $3,500. Want $3,750. The bid's $3,500. Looking for $3,750. $35, $35, $35, $35. Who wants to go ahead and top that? The bid is now $3,005. Looking for a bid of $3,750 on this. The bid's $3,500 from the National Racing Hall of Fame. A poster signed by everybody you've heard of. They're on the poster. The bid's $3,500. It's $3,500 going once. It's $3,500 going twice. Hammer down, $3,500. Thank you so much, sir. Our next item up for bid, another leather halter, and this is was worn by American Stallion Constitution. Constitution won the Grade One Florida Derby and the Don Handicap. The son of Tappet stands for $110,000 at Windstar Farms, and this is his halter. You put it on your wall, you put it in your office, you put it in your car, whatever brings you the most luck, he'll bring it to you. The opening bid on this is $500. $500 for a Constitution altar. The opening bid is $500. Looking for a bid of $500. Opening bid of $5 for a altar by Constitution. Only bid's $500. This has many uses on your farm and in the privacy of your home. You get to pick it, but it's worn by a famous stallion, Constitution, who won Grade One races as a world-renowned stallion now. $110,000 stallion. You can have his halter for $500. Let's get that first opening bid on the board. Looking for a $500 bid. Looking for a $500 opening bid. The five bid's $500. I have a $500 bid. Looking for an opening bid of $500 for a Constitution halter. Opening bid's $500. Does somebody want to try to steal this for $300? I'll go to $300. Opening bid for $300. Halter by Constitution. You're going to hurt this horse's feelings, and believe me, he has work to do next spring. The opening bid, $300, over $300 bid for a halter worn by Constitution. $300 bid for this stallion's halter. A bid's $300, looking for $300, looking for $3, looking for $3, looking for $3. Looking for three. Who wants to make an opening bid? Shout out your favorite number. $29.95. Thank you, Mr. Rockefeller. Perfect. Okay. Let's go with an opening bid of $100. $100 opening bid for Constitution. $100 bid for this halter. I've got $100 now. Let's go to two. Got one. Go two. Got $100 looking for $200. Got $100 looking for two. Now I've got $200. Is that two? Did I spot her? Do I have two? Do I have two? I've got two. Looking for three. I have 200. Looking for three. Got 200. Looking for three. 200 on the left side. Looking for three over here. Got $200 bid made over here. Looking for three. The bid's 200. We're going to move it right along. The bid's 200. Looking for 250. 200. Looking for 250. Looking for 2.5. 2.5. 2.5. The bid's 200. The 200 once. The bid's 200 twice. Oh, I've got 250. Thank you. Late to the party. $250 bid. Thank you so much. The bid's 250. Looking for three. Now I've got three. Got two. Now I've got three. Got three. Looking for four. Now I've got four. Looking for five. I started at five. Where were you? The bid's 400. Looking for five. 500. I'll say that extra slow. Thank you again, sir. $500 bid.
There you go.
$500 bid. Looking for six. Got five. Looking for six. Got $500. Looking for 600. 500. 500. Looking for six. 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 Looking for five. Looking for six. Got $500 made. 500 once. 500 twice. Hammer down. $500. Constitution's halter. Our next item is, again, absolutely one of a kind, as special, special, special as you can get. I'm going to tell you a little bit about this, then you're going to have a special treat. The artist who did this is going to say a few words about it as well. Artist Neil Portnoy, this is an original by him, Hall of Fame Jockeys, Hall of Fame Jockeys from Jockeys and Jeans in Las Vegas this year. He did a painting, an original work of art, which has been signed by the artist. And instead of me yakking about it up here, Mr. Portnoy, if you'd be kind enough to come up and tell us about your passion and devotion to this and what you're contributing to this wonderful cause.
My pleasure. You're giving me a microphone. I'm not going to be brief. You know what's going to happen. Hey, listen, let's give a big hand for us for Caesars doing this wonderful event for the jockeys. Now, the original artwork, if you look real closely, is signed by all the Hall of Famers here in the room that are depicted in the artwork. The original drawing, 18 by 24, is matted with an engraved plaque, Legends of Racing. One of a kind, illustrated with felt tip magic markers. It's the only medium I work in. Get a good close look at it. We will, once the original sells, make prints available, signed and numbered once again by all the jockeys, which I had the pleasure of being with last night. And the first time in my life, I felt like the number one draft choice of the San Antonio Spurs.
It's a beautiful original work of art, and it is signed by the Hall of Fame jockeys who are here. They have estimates on what these things are worth, and these things are just priceless because they're not going to be another one. You can't get another one, so you can only get this one. You can only get here. You can only get it tonight. Opening bid on this, $2,500. An opening bid, $2,500. An original work of art by an artist, Neil Portnoy, signed by the Hall of Fame jockeys here tonight. Opening bid, looking for $2,500. $2,500. I have $2,500. Opening bid is $2,500. Is that you, sir, correct? I've got my bid at 25, looking for 3,000. Got 2,500, looking for 3. Got 2,500, looking for 3,000, 3,000, 3,000. First bid is 2,500, looking for $3,000. Again, this is an original work of art. There's not going to be another one. The signatures on it are just great to have. The work of art in itself is great to have. You put them two together, you've got a wonderful piece for your home. The opening bid is $2,500. 2,500, looking for 3. Got 2,500, looking for 3,000. Got 2,500, looking for 3. 25, 25, 25, looking to bid up to 3. Got 25, looking for $3,000. Opening bid is 2,500, looking for 3,000. I've got $2,500 bid. We're going to push this right along. Ed?
Let me just say one thing. This is a one-of-a-kind piece of art by a well-known and famous artist. This is a choice piece. There's only one of these. You're talking about pinhooking, or you're talking about investing in art. This is not a buy. This is an investment. And I guarantee you it will pay dividends.
He guarantees it, so he'll buy it back for $3,000 if you make the $2,500 bid up that. The opening bid is $2,500. Looking for $3,000. I got $2,500. Looking for three. Looking for three. Looking for three. Got $2,500. Maybe looking for $3,000. $2,500 bid. The bid's $2,500. $2,500. Original work of art by Neil Portnoy. The bid is $2,500. I'm looking for $3,000. Mr. Portnoy's works sell for tens of thousands of dollars. So this is an absolute, absolute value. He's done portraits of very, very famous athletes, people like LeBron James and Brett Favre, people of that nature. And he's got our jockeys on this poster here tonight. An original work of art signed by the Hall of Famers. The bid's $2,500. I'm looking for $3,000. $2,500. Looking for three. Looking for three. Looking for three. I've got a bid of $2,500. $2,500 is going once. $2,500 is going twice. Hammer down, you own it, $2,500. Thank you so much, sir. Our next item up for bid is something very, very special. Artist Selena Ramsey print, this title is called Timeless Moment. It is a Secretariat, the 1973 Triple Crown winner. This has been signed by Secretariat's owner, Penny Chenery, and his Hall of Fame jockey, Ron Turcott. You say the word Secretariat, people who don't know that horses have four hooves know who he is. This horse's legacy lives on for over 40 years. I mean, for him to be that well known so many years after his racing and life just speaks volumes about what he did for the country when he raced and the collectability of this item. It's a beautiful piece. Mrs. Chenery was kind enough to sign it, as was Mr. Turcott. This would look more than fabulous any place you put it in your home or your office. The opening bid on this is $500. Remember, $500 opening bid. Opening bid of $500. I've got $500. Looking for $1,000. I got $1,000. This is Secretariat's owner and jockey, signed on a beautiful print of Big Red himself. The opening bid is $500. Looking for $1,000. The opening bid is $1,000. I got $1,000. Got $1,000. Got $1,000. Got $500. Won $1,000 bid. I've got $500 made. Looking for $1,000. Opening bid is $500. Looking for $1,000 bid for this piece. I've got an opening bid of $500. $500 over here. I'm looking for $1,000. Let's go to $750. I've got $750. Got $750. Now looking for $1,000. Got $7.50. Want a full $10. Got $7.50. Looking for $1,000. $750 bid. $750. Looking for $1,000 bid. $750. I've got. I'm looking for a grand. $750. Looking for one large. Got $750 made. Ed.
Secretariat is a legend. This is an opportunity for you to put a legend on your wall. He won all three Triple Crown races in time that 50 years ago to this day has never been topped. He's no doubt probably the best horse that ever drew breath or wore a bridle. And here he is with Penny Chenery, his famous owner. You might have seen the movie Secretariat and talked about her, and she broke the ceiling in some regards as a female owner in horse racing. And this is a beautiful piece. Anyone would be proud to have it. Anyone walks in your home and you have this in your home, they're going to notice this, and you're going to have a wonderful conversation piece. If you have a business, you can brag on this to everybody that comes in your door. Secretariat, right. And Penny Chenery.
Our opening bid is $500. I've already did $750. You got $500. We went to $750. Who was my $750 bid? $750 bid, looking for $1,000. Looking for $1,000, got $750 made, looking for $1,000. Looking for $1,000, got $7.50 made, looking for $1,000. $750 bid. I've got $1,000. Do I have $1,000 back here? Do I have $1,000 bid? I've got $1,000 bid, so I don't have to wait anymore. $1,000 is bid, looking for $1,250. Yes, sir. No worries, my bid's $1,000. Yes, sir.
This is the last time she signed.
Yeah. This was the person who obtained the signatures, drove and flew all around the world. This was the last signature that Penny Chenery ever autographed. This was the last of her signatures. She died only weeks after she signed this. She was a living legend in horse racing. One of the greatest women to ever take part in horse racing. And this is living part of history.
Our current bid's $1,000 for this piece. Got $1,000 bid, looking for $1,250. Got $1,000 bid, $1,000, looking for $1,250. Got $1,000 looking for $1,250, $1,250, $1,250. The bid's $1,000. The bid's $1,000. Can I go to $1,250? With anybody in the room, $1,250. The bid's $1,000, looking for $1,250. $1,250, $1,000 bid once. $1,000 called twice. Hammer down, $1,000, sold. Thank you so very, very much. We have another halter here, and this is special as well. This is a leather halter worn by Eclipse champion American Stallion Run Happy. Run Happy set a Grade 1 Breeders' Cup sprint record. His breeding says his courses can go a lot further than that. So this is a Run Happy halter, and this would be a great thing to have. He stands at Claiborne for $15,000. This is his halter. And if you buy this, there are a couple benefits that go along with this. If you buy this, if you pay enough for this, it allows you to stop hearing the Run Happy ads on TVG in your sleep, which is a huge bonus. When I watch TVG, my wife calls it the Run Happy Channel. That's how many ads run for this guy. So if you want to quiet that second voice in your mind while you sleep, let's put up a bid for this great halter. A Run Happy halter, Eclipse Champion, and American Stallion Run Happy. Opening bid, $500 for a Run Happy halter. $500 for a Run Happy bid. Let's have $500 blinger, $500, $500. $500 bid for this bridal. Our last bridal opening bid was for $200. Now I'll go to that for this one. $200 opening bid. Thank you very much. Not going out looking for three. Got two looking for $300. The bid's $200 looking for $300. The bid's $200 looking for three. $300. I got three. Do I have three? I've got $300. Thank you so much. $300 bid looking for $400. The bid is three looking for $400. Bid is $300. I'm looking for four. I've got three, and I'm looking for four. I've got four. Looking for four. Looking for five. $400. I'm looking for $500. The bid's $415. The bid's $415. Look at $500 bid. Looking for a $500 bid for this. The bid is now $400. Looking for four and a half. Fat five in the back of the room. Thank you, sir. The bid's now five. Looking for six. The bid is five. Looking for six. Now I've got six. Looking for seven. I've got $600. Looking for seven. You two want to sit close to each other so you can actually fight it out. The bid is $600, looking for $700. $600 bid, looking for $700. The bid is $666666, looking for $700. Do I have $700? Do I have $700 on the right side of the room? I've got $600 bid back here. Do I have $700 in the back of the room? The bid is currently six. The bid is six. Spotters, check your bidders. $650. Oh, yeah, I understand $650. I'm just insulted by it, but I get it. Yeah, we got it. $650 is my bid, looking for $700. Bid six and a half, one $700 bid. The bid is six and a half. Now I've got seven. Seven over here. I've got seven, my $700. $750 is not an insult. Will you? $750. Thank you, sir. Looking for eight. You're not finished. We're nowhere getting done with you yet. It's a bid $750 and looking for eight. I've got $800 bid for this. A Run Happy halter, $800 bid. You trying to jack the price of the halter or the stallion himself? We're not sure. The bid's $800 though, and I'm looking for nine. I got $800, looking for $900. The bid is now $800, and I'll take $850, but the bid's currently $800. Looking for eight, got eight, looking for nine, got eight, looking for nine, $800, looking for $900 bid. The bid is eight once.
I want to say something. Do you know that the owner of Run Happy is in this room tonight? Mattress Mac McInvale, who is one of a kind. And I'm going to say, I think there's room on this halter for him to sign it personalized if you buy it. You'll not only have a Run Happy halter, but you'll have one autographed by its owner. Is that all right, Mr. Mack? Perfect. Okay. Mr. Mack is going to sign this for you.
That should take us from $800 to $850 easily. Okay. $800, my bid, liver 8.5. Got handle, looking for 8.5, $850. The bid's $800, liver 8.5. Looking for 8.5, got $850. Looking for $850. I've got $800, one 8.5. Got $800, one 800. $800 going once. $800 going twice. Hammer now at $800. Run Happy's halter. Our next item up for bid, these are unique things you can get nowhere else, anywhere, any price. The Triple Crown goggles from 1973 to 2018. They are signed by Triple Crown jockeys Ron Turcotte, Jean Cruguet, Stevie Cawthon, Victor Espinoza, and Mike Smith. And Victor Espinoza was especially tough to get, but they made him do it, so we're glad to have these on air. These are jockey goggles. To explain these to people who don't know racing is a lot of fun. To explain them to people who wore these, who those people are, is going to be extra fun. They put a price on this. There is no price for this. It is just absolutely a great thing to have. Not only a racing Hall of Fame item, but a very personal item worn by the jockeys who won these great races. We're going to start our opening bid at $750. Opening bid, seven and a half. Opening bid, $750. That is five jockey goggles worn by Triple Crown winning jockeys. The opening bid is $750. And this is just a great, great one-of-a-kind item worn by one-of-a-kind athletes. Opening bid is 7.5. I got 7.5, looking for 8. Got 7.5, looking for 800. Opening bid is now 750, looking for 800. Got 800, looking for 8, looking for 8, looking for 8, looking for 8. Opening bid is $750, looking for an $800 bid. Again, the left-hand side of the room, to my left, has been to $800. Thank you, sir. Is doing great on the left, as usual. Right side of the room, I figure you owe us.
Hikers.
Our bid is $800. Now I'm looking for $8.50. Got $800, looking for $850. The bid is $800, looking for $850. $800 bid, looking for $850. Do I have $850 over here? I've got $800, looking for $8.50. I've got $850. Do I have $850 on the bid? $850. Thank you very much. Looking for $900. You're going to win one of these, sir, I promise. The bid's $850, looking for $900. We have $850, looking for $900 bid. $8.50, looking for $9, looking for $9, looking for $9. $800, $850's bid. I've got $900 now. Thank you, sir. The bid is $9. Got $9, looking for $9.50. Got $900, looking for $950. I've got $900, looking for $950. Do I have $950? I've got $900 here. I've got $950. Thank you. In the back room, front of the room, it's $9.50. Do you have $1,000 on you? Sitting with the woman you're with, I'm guessing you do. The bid's $950. How about $1,000? It's only $50 more, pal. I've got $1,000. Thank you very much. The bid's now $1,000. Now we're at $1,000. Let's go a little higher. The bid's $1,000. Looking for $1,100. Got $1,000. Looking for $1,100. Got one looking for $1,100. Got $1,000. Looking for $1,100. The bid's $1,111. I got a grand looking for $1,100. The bid's $1,000. That is $200 per pair of goggles, sir. That's cheaper than the sunglasses you've got on. God bless you. This is fabulous. $1,000 bid, looking for $1,100. The bid's $1,001. Got $1,001. I've got $1,100 over here. Now I've got $11, looking for $12. Got $11,112. Got $11,112. Got $11, looking for $1,200. The bid's $11, looking for $12. The bid's $1,100. We're at $11, looking for $1,200. $1,200. We'll probably take this home. Who's going to throw up a hand? And now I've got $1,200. I got $12. Thank you, sir. The bid is $12, looking for $13. 13's a lucky number in this room. The bid's $12, want $13. 12, looking for $13. The bid's $1,200, looking for $1,300. Got $1,200 made, looking for $13. $1,200. $1,200. $1,300. Do I have it? Killing me with these $50 bills. Killing me. $1,500. Good. You lost the 50s. God bless you, sir. $1,500. $1,500 bid. Looking for more. $1,500. Looking for $16. $1,500. That is $300 per pair of goggles. These get worth more by the minute. The bid's $1,005. Looking for $1,006. Got $1,005. $1,006. $1,005. I have $1,006. I've got $1,600. Thank you, sir. The bid is $16. Looking for $17. The bid's $16. Want $17. The bid is $16. Looking for $1,700. $16. May. Looking for $17. 16's on the board. Looking for $1,007. Got $1,600. May. Looking for $1,700. This is going once at $1,600. This is going twice. Hammer down, $1,600. Thank you very much, sir. Beautiful bid. Our next item up for bid. This is a jockey's boot signed by the Kentucky Derby jockeys from the 149th running of the Derby. That was last year. That was this year's Derby. So all the Derby jockeys that saw Mage go across the wire first have signed this boot. There's a lot of things you can do to get a jockey's boot. None of them can be mentioned in a family setting. So here is your chance to get one the legitimate way. This had been signed by all the jockeys in the 149th Kentucky Derby, and to have them all on one piece of racing memorabilia is a great thing to have in your home or office. Opening bid on this. We're going to make it a $500 opening bid. I want $500. $500 opening bid for the jockey's boot. I've got five. I'm looking for six. I've got $516. $500 bid. Looking for $600. The bid is five. I'm looking for six. The bid is $500. $600. Our bid is at $500. Looking for a $600 bid on a jockey's boot. Signed by the jockeys this year's Derby. They all put their name and numbers on it. The bid is $500. Looking for six. $500. Opening bid, looking for $600. $500 made, looking for $666666. I've got $500, looking for $600. The bid is now $500, looking for six. Let me see this, Ed, for a second. Nobody wore it. This thing is brand new, okay?
It's one of a kind.
It's absolutely one of a kind because we don't have the one that matches it. So this is the right-hand boot, by the way, so we don't know where the left one is, and it's not going to matter. Opening bid is $500, I want $600. $500 opening bid, looking for six, got five, want six, 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 got $500, looking for $600. I got five, looking for six, left five, looking for six. Do I have six over here? Got $500. $500 bid once. $500 bid twice. Hammer down, $500 jockey boot from the 149th Kentucky Derby. Our next item up for bid was worn by a horse that cost me an awful lot of money. If I can get through this without weeping, it's going to be a miracle. When Rich Strike went by Epicenter in the Kentucky Derby 2022, I went into grief counseling for about 7 months after that. This was This gives me both great joy and great pain to introduce this item to you. Leather halter won by 2022 Kentucky Derby winner Rich Strike. This has been signed by his jockey, Sonny Leone, and you get an official Churchill Downs winner's photo of Rich Strike with Sonny Leone and trainer Eric Reed. I'm good friends with someone who's good friends with Mr. Reed and Mr. Leone, and I'm telling you, these people are as nice as you hope they are. You hear stories about people in the sports world, and you hope they're as nice as they appear to be. You can make that times 10 for both these gentlemen. Both Sonny and Eric are just terrific, terrific human beings. For them to have this moment in their Kentucky Derby is just a great thing. At 80-1, he wins his Derby. You can have the halter from Rich Strike for your collection. If I had any money left from last year, I'd buy it myself. Our opening bid on this is $700. I want a $700 opening bid. The opening bid is $700. $700 opening bid. Rich Strike's halter, an 80-1 shot winning the Kentucky Derby. Let's have an opening bid on this fabulous piece of memorabilia. $700 opening bid. Looking for $700. Looking for $700 for Rich Strike's halter. He wasn't in the Derby until Friday afternoon, and he wins this race. The story behind this horse is going to make this worth a lot of money. It's a great story. I've got a $700 opening bid. I do not. I've got more than that. $500 opening bid. Perhaps I wasn't clear. Opening bid is now $500. Before we go any further, they're making about three different movies at the same time on this horse's Kentucky Derby story. They're making a movie about the horse. They're making a movie about the Reeds. They're making a movie. I mean, this is going to have cachet. This is going to have collectability behind it for years to come. Rich Strike's Kentucky Derby. He wasn't in the race on the Friday afternoon. I've got $500. I need six out of the back of the room. I got $500 opening bid, looking for $600. I got $500. Got $500. Got $600. $600. Thank you, sir. $600 opening bid. Now I have six. I'm looking for seven. I've got six. I'm looking for seven. Got six. I've got seven. Looking for $800. My bid $700. Looking for eight. Got $777. Looking for $800. The bid is 718. Looking at seven. Do only six people in this room have anything in their wallet? That's who I'm looking at right here. I've got a bid of $600, looking for $700. The bid is not six, looking for seven. The bid is six, looking for $700. I've got seven, looking for eight. The bid, seven, looking for $800. The bid is now seven, looking for eight, $700. Seven bid, seven bid, $700. Bid, looking for $800. Rich Strike's halter, $700. Now I've got $800 bid. Got eight, looking for nine. Got eight, well, $900. Got $100, looking for nine. The bid is eight, looking for $900. When this movie comes out, when all three of them come out, you're going to wish you had this. One more time.
850.
I hear you. I've got enough pictures of U.S. Grant already. $850. Thank you for that bid. The bid's $850, looking for $900. The bid's $850, looking for $900. The bid's $850. I've got $900, looking for $1,000. I got $9 already, looking for $1,000. The bid's $999, looking for $1,000 bid. I got. I've got a $900 bid. Right here. The bid's $900. It's a very fair bid. $1,000 would be much fairer. The bid's $900, looking for $1,000. Got $950. Would I have $950 in the back of the room? It's just another picture of Ulysses. I've got $900 bid, looking for $950. I've got $900 bid, looking for $1,000 in the back of the room. Got $100 bid here, looking for $1,000 to my right, $1,000 to my left, $950 straight ahead.
You know, there's a lot of major players in this room, I'm told, and I met several on the way in. And if nothing else, if you're a Kentucky Derby bettor, you could put just piece on your wall and tell everybody how much money you lost on the Kentucky Derby. Where are you at, you high rollers?
This thing is actually stained with the tears of Epicenter Betting, so, you know, it's actually there. The bid is $900. I'm going to up that to $950 or $1,000. The bid is $900. I've got a bid of $900. $900 going once. $900. Do I have $950? I've got $950. Thank you, sir. Late to the party, but here the bid's $9.50. Looking for $1,000. $950. Looking for a grand. Got $950. Looking for $1,000 bid. Now I've got my $1,000. Looking for $11. Got $1,000 bid. Looking for $1,100. $1,000. Looking for $1,100. The bid's $1,000. Looking for $1,050. Anything for $50 more. The bid's $1,000. Looking for $11. Got $1,000 bid. Do I have $1,100? Got $1,000 up here. Do I have an $11 out of you? $1,000 going once. $1,000 going twice. Hammer down, $1,000, Rich Strike's halter, and Kentucky Derby photograph. This next item, wow. Just wow. It's a custom barrow saddle. It's done in red and black. It is signed by the 149th Kentucky Derby Jockey Colony. All the jockeys in the 149th Derby signed this. And it's just a beautiful piece of art, as well as a beautiful piece of horse racing equipment. It's just a great thing to have. You can take your chances and use it on your horse and wear the signatures off. I'm sure all the ones on the seat would love to have your butt on top of them, but that's not the point here. The point is that you get great signatures on a great piece of racing equipment. Let's start our opening bid for this beautiful racing saddle, a Compton Barrow saddle in red and black. Opening bid, this is $800. $800 opening bid, $800 for this saddle. Anybody know what these saddles go for new? Ed, any idea what these cost new? I go to have one of these made, what's it set me back?
The saddle itself would cost $800. I mean, worst case scenario, you could buy it and give it to your favorite jockey to ride with. It's worth $800. It's worth a lot more as a memento with all these signatures on it. It's a keepsake you'll have forever.
It's worth $100 to sit on Flavian Pratt. Absolutely. Yes, it is. So opening bid on this $800. Opening bid, $800. Delivered $800. Delivered $800 bid for this beautiful, beautiful custom-made saddle. I've got $800. I've got $800. Looking for $9. Got $8. Looking for $900. I've got $800. Looking for $9. Looking at $100. The bid is $800. Looking for $900. I got $800. Looking for $900 bid. $800 bid, looking for $9. Mr. Boland, you want to come have a ride on this real quickly just to see if it still kind of fits under there? The bid's $800, looking for $900. The bid's $800, looking for $900. The bid's $8, looking for $900 bid. This saddle is absolutely gorgeous. It's a work of art. It's a work of athletic equipment, and it's got signatures on it. They're going to be in the Hall of Fame. Some of them already are. So this is a great thing to have. The bid is $900. Underneath.
Yes, these are all the riders that rode in
yes.
the Kentucky Derby.
Every signature on here rode in the 149th Derby, so it's collectible from that
riders.
Aspect as well. All right, I'm a little confused here. Our bid over here is $800. Now I'm looking for $9. I got $800 looking for $9, $800 bid, looking for $900 bid. The bid is $8, looking for $9. The bid is $800. Do I have anything more than that? $800. Do I have $850? He went to the bathroom. Perfect timing. The bid's $800, looking for $8.50. My bid is $800, deliver $850. The bid is $800 going once on this custom-made saddle. $800 going twice on this beautiful piece of leather, stitchery, and autographed jockeys. Hammer down, third time, $800 sold. Surprise, 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 another horse halter coming to the auction stage. You can make history or you can buy history, and this is your chance to buy history. This is a leather halter worn by 2018 Triple Crown winner and champion stallion Justify. Justify won his Triple Crown in 2018. He stands for $100,000 at Ashford Farms. This is a Triple Crown winning halter. Few and far between, a rare item indeed. Opening bid on this. I want to see an opening bid of at least $1,000 for this, and I've got an opening bid of $1,000, looking for $1,250. Opening bid is $1,000, looking for $1,250. I got opening bid of $1,000, won $1,250. $1,000, my opening bid, looking for something up from that. Looking for $1,250. This is Justify, his halter. Justify did not race as a three-year-old. He won his Derby. Just as a two-year-old, I mean, yeah, he won his Derby, unraced it at two as a three-year-old. Records there in itself. A great, great horse. Be a fabulous stallion. He stands for $100,000. You can get him for $1,000. I'm opening bids, $1,000. Looking for $1,250. Looking for a bid of $1,250. $1,250. Looking for $1,250. I got $1,250. Got $1,250. Looking for $1,500. The bid's $1,250. Looking for $1,500. $1,250 is on the phone. This could be great. Got an opening bid at $1,250. Got $1,250 on the phone to somebody. Looking to up from that. I'm going to go ahead and fake a bid so he'll keep adding more. Is that okay with you? The bid's $1,250, deliver $1,500. I got $1,250, deliver $1,500. $1,250, deliver $1,500. I got $1,250, deliver $1,500. There's only $250 more. The bid's $1,250. Do I have $15? Do I have $15? The bid's $12.50. Do I have $15? I'm looking for $1,500 bid. I've got $1,250 made, deliver $1,500. Justifies Halter, Triple Crown Champion. There are very few of these and even fewer of these that you're ever going to be able to buy.
I know there's a lot of Bob Baffert fans in this room, and Bob, for whatever anybody says, he was a great donor to Jockeys and Jeans, was a great supporter of the PDJF. And Bob Baffert is actually the only living Triple Crown winning trainer. This horse was trained by Bob Baffert. I know there's some Bob Baffert fans in this room tonight, and this is honor of Bob Baffert, who was our past Man of the Year and who is an incredible man who loves jockeys.
Justifies Halter, the bid's 1,250, looking for 1,500. 1,250, looking for 15, got 1,200, looking for 1,500. 1,500, the bid's 1,250, looking for 1,500. 1,250, 1,250, 1,250, 1,250, looking for 15, 1,250 once. 1,250 twice. Hammer down, $1,250. Thank you so much, sir. I promise you this next halter is a different one from the one you just saw up here. This was worn by 2015 Triple Crown winner and American Stallion, American Pharoah. American Pharoah broke a 37-year drought in the Triple Crown Championship Series, and the world watched in amazement. If you ever heard the call of that race, it's something you'll never forget. American Pharoah now stands for $60,000 at Ashford Farm. You can have a piece of history, a Triple Crown winner's personal halter with his brass nameplate on it. Opening bid on this, he broke the 37-year drought for our Triple Crown. The opening bid's $1,000. $1,000 opening bid. The opening bid's $1,000. I got $1,000 over $1,250. I got $1,000, won $1,250. The opening bid's now $1,000. I've got that liver $1,250. I've got $1,000 over $1,250, $1,250, $1,250. Looking for more than that. I got $1,000 made, looking for $1,250. The opening bid's $1,000 on American Pharoah. And since they spelled Pharoah wrong, it's even more collectible, believe me. That makes it worth even more. His name is spelled correctly, but when they named him, they spelled his name wrong. So that's just part of the fun of this horse. The opening bid is $1,000. Now I'm looking for $1,250. The opening bid is $1,250. Looking for $1,250. Got $1,000 for $1,250. I've got $1,250. I got $1,250 in the back of the room. Thank you, sir. $1,250. Looking for $1,500. The bid is $1,250. I got $1,000. Looking for $1,500. $1,250. Looking for $1,500. I got $1,250. $1,500. I got $1,250. Looking for $1,500. $1,500. Looking for $1,250. I got $1,250. Looking for $1,500. Looking for $1,500. Looking for $1,500. I got $1,250. I got to have $1,500. Thank you, ma'am. $1,500. Thank you very much. The bid's $1,500. Looking for $1,600. I got $1,516. $1,516. The bid's $1,500. Looking for $1,006. Got $1,500. Looking for $1,600. Got $1,500 bid. Looking for $1,006. The bid's at $1,500. $1,500 going once. $1,500 going twice. American Pharoah's halter, Triple Crown winner, $1,500. Hammer down, sold, $1,500. Thank you very much.
These two didn't meet the reserves.
I'm sorry?
These two didn't meet the reserves. It happened. No big deal, but this member got one here, too.
Okay.
Huh?
You need to announce that, I guess.
All right. Should I announce that?
That there was a $2,500 reserve.
Okay. I think so. I need to just tell the people who won the bid that they
won the bid.
All right, our next item up for bid is something just amazingly special. Everyone who knows horse racing knows the Kentucky Derby. People around the world who know nothing about horse racing know the Kentucky Derby. And this is a Legends of the Kentucky Derby signed poster. This has over 74 years of Kentucky Derby history signed on this. It was signed by every Kentucky Derby winning jockey except for one for the last 74 years. This has owners on it as well. Mrs. Chenery's signature is on this as well. We have owners, jockeys, and trainers on this poster. It's an incredible one-of-a-kind piece. The poster itself is beautiful. The signatures are absolutely priceless. Ed, you have something to add?
Yeah, there's a couple signatures on here. One is Ron Franklin, who won the Kentucky Derby in the Preakness on the Incredible Horse Spectacular bid when he was only 18 years old. And sadly, he died of cancer in his 40s. This is one of the last of anything you will see signed by him. And there are only four of these left. We sold one for $10,000. At Saratoga, and I'm just wondering, this is a Las Vegas crowd. Are you going to let Saratoga beat you? Wow. Wait a minute. I thought we were in the land of the high rollers and the free spenders here tonight.
I want to say a little bit about what it took to get these signatures on this poster. I've got a sheet here that tells me what they went through to get these signatures. The first 56 signatures on this, 14 plane trips to Florida, New York, California, Colorado, Pennsylvania, and Kentucky to get the signatures on this. That's a lot of plane tickets. That's a lot of travel. That's a lot of passion and a lot of energy to put this thing together. 74 years of Kentucky Derby history. Every jockey and trainer, except for one, has signed this for the last 74 years. It is just a great, great, great thing to have. Again, the poster is beautiful. The signatures are priceless. And this does have a reserve on it of $5,000. So we're going to need a $5,000 bid on this to take this home. I will open the bidding at $3,500 to get it started, but this does have a reserve. Opening bid, $3,500 for this Kentucky Derby winning jockeys poster, owners, trainers, and jockeys for the last 74 years. Not only can you never get anything else like this, it's impossible to get anything else approaching this. This is absolutely a one-of-a-kind piece. So I'd like someone to unbutton their purse, open their wallet for an opening bid of $3,500 over an opening bid of $3,500. Opening bid of $3,500 for an opening bid of $3,500. I want $3,500,005. Got $3,500. There is a reserve on this, so opening bid of $35 may not take this. Now I'm looking for four. Got $35, one, $4,000. $4,000 for that. I got $3,500. Looking for $4,000. Looking for a $4,000 bid on this. I got $3,500 made. Looking for four. Looking for four. Looking for four. We're going to have to get to five to send it home. The opening bid is $3,500. I'm looking for four. Got $3,500. Looking for $4,000. Got $3,500. Looking for four. Looking for four. Looking for four. Again, right side of the room. Where are you? The opening bid is $3,500. Looking for $4,000. Got $3,500 made. Looking for four. Got $3,500. Now I've got four. Are you, ma'am, are you waving at the back of the room or waving at me? The opening bid is $3,500. Do I have $4,000? I got a $3,500 bid in the back. Looking for four. Do I have $4,000? She's discussing it with six other people at the table. Do I have $4,000? $4,000 bid. Thank you. Looking for $4,500. $4,500. I've got $4,000. Looking for $4,005. The bid's $4,000. Need $4,500. There is a reserve on this, so it does need to go at a little higher price. Let's get it up there now. The bid's $4,000. Looking for $4,250. The current bid, $4,000. Looking for $4,250. $4,050. Now I've got $4,250. $4,050 in the back. Looking for $4,500. Looking for $4,005. Looking for $4,500. I've got $4,250. Looking for $4,005. $4,250. $4,250. Looking for $4,005. $4,500 is the next bid I need to hear. This has been signed every Kentucky Derby winning jockey save one for the last 74 years, plus owners, plus trainers on a Derby poster. The bid is $4,500, and we need to bump it just a little bit, just a hair. As they say in racing, let's bump it by a nose. The bid's $45. I need $4,750 for my next bid. Looking for $4,750. $4,750. Looking. Bid's $4,500. Looking for $4,750. Looking for $4,750 to push this towards the top. Let's see a bid on that. $4,750. Looking for five. $4,750. Looking for $5,000. $5,000 is needed to get this going, and I want it. Then somebody's off. I've got five. I've got my reserve. $5,000 bid. Thank you, sir. Our reserve is met. Thank you. $5,000 bid. But it doesn't have to stop there. $5,000 made. Looking for $5,500. The bid's $5,000. Looking for $5,500. Got $5,000 bid. Making for $5,500. $5,000 bid. Looking for $5,500. The bid's $5,000. A lot of people in this room know a lot of people on this poster. A lot of people in this room know that a lot of people on this poster cannot be reached again for something like this. Our bid is $5,000. We're looking for $5,500. One of a kind item. Never again. Nothing like it again. The bid is $5,000. Looking for $5,500. Do I have 55? Do I have 55? The only bid, $5,500. $5,500. I've got $5,000 made. I've got $5,000 once. What's my bid over here, bid spotter? The bid's $5,000. Looking for $5,500. $5,000. Last bid is $5,000. Looking for $5,500. $5,000 going once. $5,000 going twice. Hammer down $5,000 for a winning bid. Our next item up for bid, very interesting. This is a trio of whiskeys, two bourbons and a rye. These come from Kentucky. These are hand-painted carved glass bourbon bottles. These were commemoratives featuring the 50th edition of Secretariat on the Angel's Envy bottle. The Belmont Stakes is commemorated on the Rabbit Hole bourbon bottle, and the Great Horse Flight Line is on the bottle of Willet Rye. You get three bottles of Kentucky Whiskey, Turbobrins, and a rye, and this is donated by Racing Expressions. A collector's edition of the 50th anniversary of Secretariat features him on the Angel's Envy bottle, which is on the far my right here. And you've got the Rabbit Hole Bourbon is the second one, and the Flight Line, the Willet Rye, is the third one. Three bottles of whiskey. This will certainly get you through the night and maybe beyond that. Opening bid on these collectible bottles commemorating Secretariat's 50th anniversary of his Derby win, Belmont Stakes, and Flight Line Breeders winner. Let's have an opening bid of $100. Opening bid of $100. Opening dollars. Opening got $100. Bid liver two. Got one liver two. Got $100. Bid liver 200. I got 200. Looking for three. Got 200. Looking for 300. 300. Got $200. Looking for 300. $200 bid. Now I've got three. Got three. Looking for four. $1,000. $1,000 bid. You must have tasted these long before I did. $1,000 opening bid, not $1,000 bid. I'm looking for $1,100. The bid's $1,000, looking for $1,001. The bid's $1,000, looking for $11. Do I have $1,100 or do I have $1,050? I got $1,100. Thank you very much. Ben Franklin came to the party. $1,100 bid, looking for $1,002. Looking for $1,200. The bid's $11, looking for $1,200. The bid's $1,100, looking for $12. I got $11, looking for $12. Now I've got $12. Now I've got $12, looking for $13. The bid's $12, looking for $1,300. $1,200, looking for $13. $1,200, $1,200, $1,200. Looking for $1,300. $1,200, looking for $13. I've got $1,200 bid here, looking for $1,300. $1,200, $300. Do I have $13? I've got $1,300. Thank you very much. $1,300 bid. $1,300 is the current bid. Three collectible, beautiful bottles of bourbon whiskey. Add them to your liquor cabinet. Add them to your collection, or bust them open and serve them in the back of the room. It's all good for us. The bid's $1,003. Looking for higher than that. Looking for $1,004. $1,300. Looking for $1,400. I got $13. Looking for $14. I got $13. Looking for $14. $13. Looking for $14. I got $1,400 bid. $1,004. Looking for $15. The bid's $14. Looking for $15. $14. Looking for $15. $1,400 bid, looking for $1,005. The bid is $1,004, looking for $1,500. $1,500 bid. $1,005 is mid bid, looking for $16. The bid's $15,116. $1,005, looking for $1,006. Got $1,500, looking for $1,600. $1,500, looking for $1,600. $1,600. I've got my $1,600, looking for $17. I got $16,117. $1,600, looking for $1,700. $1,700, $1,600 bid. Do I have $17? I got $16 in front. Do I have $17 in back? $1,600 bid, looking for $17. $1,700. Fair enough. I got 1,007. 1,700, looking for 1,800. I got 1,007, middle of 1,800. This could go with two. I got $1,700, looking for 1,800. 1,017, 1,700, 17, 17, 17. Do I have 18? I've got 17. $1,700. $1,700 going once. $1,700 going twice. Hammer down, $1,700. Thank you, sir. Well bid. Well done. Got it? Okay. Our final item up for live auction bid is it's history, it's a life's experience, it's something that people wait all their lives to do. Many people get to, many people do not. Many more don't than do. This is donated by Churchill Downs. It is for the 150th running of the Kentucky Derby. This includes six tickets to the Kentucky Oaks and the Kentucky Derby Experience at Churchill Downs. It's in section 324, prime seating for both the Kentucky Oaks and the Kentucky Derby. Ed?
I would invite anybody here, get on your cell phone and see what it costs to buy a box at the Kentucky Derby Day and also the Kentucky Derby Oaks. I mean, if you want something to resell, if you want something that is a once-in-a-lifetime experience for you and five others, this is probably the best opportunity you're going to have in your life to do this. Churchill Downs doesn't normally give away boxes, but we did our last event there. They were very kind to us. So we have a box, six seats to the Derby, six seats to the Oaks. this is something I suggest you try to buy otherwise.
I will tell you that Churchill Downs will be the 150th running of the Derby. The paddock, the new paddock will be finished. The track renovations will be finished. This is going to be, they're going to make this an incredible experience for everybody that walks through the gates. And you'll get to bring five of your friends to the Oaks and the Derby for the most memorable weekend in someone's life. This is a bucket list item for thousands and thousands of people around the world, and it can be yours on this fabulous, fabulous package donated by Churchill Downs. Again, this is six tickets, section 324, Churchill Downs for the 150th running of the Kentucky Derby. This includes Oaks tickets on Friday, Derby tickets on Saturday, and something you and your family or whoever gets these seats will never, ever, ever forget. The opening bid on this, $5,000, looking for $5,000 opening bid. Opening bid on this is $5,000. I've got an opening bid of $5,000. Thank you, sir. Opening bid is $5,000, looking for $6,000. $5,000 bid, looking for $6,000. I've got $5,000, looking for $6,000. Now I've got $6,000, looking for $7,000. The bid is now $6,000, looking for $7,000. Looking for $7,777. The bid is $6,000, looking for $7,000. I can absolutely promise you, if you bring $6,000 to the front gate of Churchill Downs at next year's Derby, you'll be asked to find another place to park, okay? This is just a fabulous thing to be able to be a part of. My bid is now $6,000. I'm looking for $7,000. Now I've got $7,000, looking for $8,000. The bid is now $7,000 or $8,000. $6,500? They're still going to ask you to find another place to park. I can promise you that. $6,500, looking for $7,000. Do I have $7,000? I've got my $7,000. Thank you so much. $7,000, looking for $7,500. The bid $7,000, looking for $7,500. $7,000, bid looking for $7,500. Scott Seven, looking for $7,500. The bid is $7,000, looking for $7,500. Again, if you try to get anything like this anytime during that week, you will not be able to. The bid is $7,000. What do I have? $7,500? $7,500. Got $7,500. Now I've got $8,000. The bid's now at $8,000, looking for $8,500. Got $8,000, looking for $8,500. $8,000 bid, looking for $8,500. The bid's $8,000 for $8,500. $8,000 bid. Got $8,500. $8,500 looking for $9,000. $8,500 looking for $9,000. The bid's $8,500, looking for $9,999. Got $8,500 on the table. $9,000 may or may not take it home. The bid's $8,500 looking for $9,000. I've got $8,500 looking for $9,000. Looking for $9,000. I've got $9,000. Thank you very much. The bid's now $9,000 looking for $10,000. Not kind, looking for $10,000. Let's make it $10,000. The bid's $9,000 looking for $10,000. The bid's $9,000 looking for $10,000. Again, $9,000 may or may not get you anywhere near this box on Derby Day. $10,000, you may well take it home. The bid's $9,000 looking for $10,000. Got $9,000 looking for $10,000 bid. $9,000. $9,000 is my bid. The bid's $10,000? $10,000 is my bid now. I got $10,000 looking for higher than that. The bid's now $10,000, looking for $11,000. We're at $10,000 looking for $11,000. $10,000 looking for $11,000. I've got $10,000 bid, looking for $11,000 bid. $10,000, and believe me, for this event, on this date, at this racetrack, now it's $11,000. Now we're starting to get to where this is real value. $11,000 is looking for $12,000. $11,000, maybe looking for $12,000. Again, this is a historical day at the track, two historical days at the track, the Oaks and the Derby, 6C, section 324 at Churchill Downs for the 150th running. The bid's $11,000, looking for $12,000, looking for $12,000. That's only $2,000 a seat, and that is a bargain, bargain, bargain. The bid is $11,000, looking for $12,000. Who, $2,000 a seat, you and five of your friends or family members, memories that'll last a lifetime, whether you want them to or not, you cannot miss your opportunity to do this. The bid's $11,000, looking for $12,000 bid, looking for $12,000, looking for $12,000, I've got $11,000, looking for $12,000, I've got $11,000, looking for $12,000, do I have $12,000, do I have $12,000, do I have $12,000, do I have $12,000, the bid's $11,000.
Let me just add a little perk to this. I'm going out on a limb here, but Pat Day is Pat Day. There's only one of Pat Day's. The Derby features, Derby Day features the Pat Day Stakes, Pat Day Mile. And Pat, I know you'll come up and visit the people in this box and say hello to them on this Derby Day. Is that all right, Pat? All right. Pat's going to come in your box and talk to you. He might even invite you down to the winner's circle, but I'll leave that up to him. That's a one of a kind.
The problem's not getting him to talk. The problem's getting him to, let you watch the race. Okay. The bid's $11,000. I'm looking for $12,000. I got a bid over $12,000. I got $11,000. $11,000. Looking for $12,000. The bid's stuck at $11,000, but it's worth way more than that. For only $2,000 a ticket, that makes it a $12,000 bid. This is a party of six, Oaks Derby 150th anniversary. Unbelievable memories. Unbelievable event. The bid's $11,000, and it's going to go whence? $11,000. Do I have 12? $12,000 bid. Thank you very much, sir. $12,000. Looking for more than that. $12,000. Looking for 13. Got 12. Looking for 13. $12,000 bid. Looking for 13. It's a 20-horse field. Let's do $1,000 for every horse in it. The bid's currently at $12,000. Now I have 13. The bid's 13,000. Looking for 14. 13,000. Looking for 14,000. $13,000 bid. Looking for 14. 13. 13. Looking for 14. $13,000 bid. Looking for 14. 14 large. 14 grand. 14 big ones. Now I've got it for 14. Thank you, sir. Looking for 14. Looking for 15,000. $14,000 are currently looking for 15. I got $14,000 made. Got 14 made. 14 on the table. Looking for 15. 15 might take it home. $15,000 could get you there. 14,000 made. Looking for $15,000. $14,000 are bid. Now I've got 15. $15,000 is on the table. Higher than that, let's go 16. If it's 15,000, $15,000 bid. Mr. Sunglasses, we've not heard from you in a while. Would you like to go to the Kentucky Derby and the Kentucky Oaks? If it's 15,000, looking for 16. $16,000 bid, looking for 17. $16,000 bid now before it cost you 20. The bid's, if it's 16,000, looking for 17,000. I got $16,000 bid. $16,000 is made. $16,000 on the table. $16,000 looking for 17. Got 16,1. 17. Got 16,1. 17. 16. 16. 16. Look, 17. $16,000. Kentucky Derby. Kentucky Oaks. 150th running. $16,000 is the bid. Looking for 17. $16,000 once. $16,000 twice. Pregnant pause. $16,000 sold, hammer down, $16,000 bid. Thank you all for your bids. Thank you all for your time and attention. And we'll get on with our program again for the PDJF. Thank you all so very much for opening your hearts and your wallets to this cause.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, it is now time for our Person of the Year Award, and I'm going to welcome up to the stage Mr. Ed Donnelly again, who has spent so much time up here doing a great job selling all our items. He's going to come up again for the next part. So, Ed, give you a round of applause.
You must be tired of seeing me by now. I'm loving seeing all of you here, this full house, this packed house. And bear in mind, and remember one thing. Anything you buy, every penny of it goes to those fallen riders, those brothers and sisters of ours who gave so much to this sport that we all know and love. And this is about them. This is not about us. And we thank you for that. Mattress Mac, I don't know. Mattress Mac is one of a kind. I love the guy. The more I know him, the more I like him. I tell you, he's been up in his tower. He says he's going to be there until he sells 10,000 mattresses so he can give $1 million to Camp Hope. That's the kind of guy Mac is. Just one quick story. I could tell you many, but you know, we sell Stallion Seasons to benefit the Permanently Disabled Jockeys Fund. And it's quite lucrative, and it helps, and we get a lot of donors. But Mac donated Seasons to his Run Happy, the one you hear about all the time, the famous Run Happy. Boy, is he a famous horse. But his Seasons were going for $25,000 his first years. And we sold one. We had one at auction. You bid, and you silently bid, and nobody knows who's bidding. But at the same time, the auction company made a huge mistake, and they actually told two people that they had won the bid, and both of them were very happy because it was a great, and his book was full and he was very hard to get to. Still a very successful stallion in his third year. I got to give him a plug. Run Happy's son, Smile Happy, is a multi-graded stakes winner and is about to run in the Stephen Foster Stakes, a grade one stakes, and he's the favorite. There you go, Mac, I gave you a little commercial. I know you'll appreciate it. Mac knows a lot about commercials. He once posed for a commercial surrounded by a mattress, and everybody made fun of him, and everybody laughed at him. But let me tell you, he sells like $5 million worth of mattresses a day. He's one of the greatest innovators, the greatest entrepreneurs that ever lived. But anyway, this Stallion Season sale, and we got two people that have believed that they buy this season. And we only had one season. We were in a jackpot. And the people that thought they bought it, they were really angry and they were really mad, and we didn't want to have a bad rap. Here we are, a bunch of former jockeys raising funds for our fallen brothers and sisters, and now we're going to be bad-mouthed all over the place? So what do? I call Mac. And I say, Mac, we're in a jackpot. We need another season in Run Happy. And believe me, he could have sold that thing for $25,000 in a heartbeat. And he said, okay, Eddie. That's Mac. That's Mattress Mac, folks. That's his generosity. That's his love. He's always been a love for jockeys. And he's always advocated for the cause of jockeys. And I know he's been touched by what he saw here tonight. And he is what we call a hay, oats, and water guy. He never used any drugs on his horses. He wanted them turned out for several hours in the afternoon so they could graze and be out of their stalls. He is a man who is anti-drug. I think he's like Nancy Reagan, say no to drugs. And racing is at a crossroads. And racing is taking heat and criticism from so many organizations because of what's happening in racing. And Mac is probably the only person that I know that I have ever met that is able to speak about the condition of horse racing as an owner, a successful horse owner, a successful breeder, and last but not least, and I hope everybody here that's a better takes part, he's also a person equipped to speak about betters. And sometimes they take a beating in this game, but he is for all three. And I'm interested, and this speech is going to be simulcast, and we're going to put it on our YouTube channel, our Jockeys and Jeans website. And we're so thankful that Mac took the time to crawl out of his tower to come over here and to speak. And is then going? He's going to fly out of here at the night, and he'll spend the night in the tower again tonight. That's Mattress Mac. He greets every person that walks into his store. He'll stand there 10 hours, and if you walk in Mattress Mac's store, he'll talk to you. That's the kind of guy Mattress Mac is. Started out with $5,000 investment. They didn't have enough money. He and his wife Linda had to sleep in their furniture store to keep the inventory. And look at him now. Look at what has happened now. He's a great story of capitalism. He's a great story of success. He's a great story of innovation. He's a great story of an entrepreneur who never gave up. Mattress Mac, come on up. And Barry, where are you? Wait a minute. Come on. We're going to give you... God bless you, Mac. We're going to give you the award first, and then you're going to speak.
Hey, man.
Well, I'm not going to get into all the accolades about Mac because I think we all know about him, but we do something every year that is important. We pick a person to be our person of the year. And these are folks that have done something significantly for racing. And I can honestly say that this fella has done that. He's been a big supporter of Jockeys and Jeans for the last number of years. He's a great guy, and he believes in what he does. So from Jockeys and Jeans, we present Mattress Mac, the 2023 Person of the Year. Let's hear it. Here, Mac, I'll take it and put it back in the box for you.
Thank you very much, Jockeys and Jeans, for that wonderful award. I appreciate it. Eddie, great to be here. Eddie only called me 600 times to get me to this event. And I do about 500 speeches a year. I was going to have to sit through a 12-hour auction before I got up to do this speech. Say, Eddie, what was the name of the auctioneer? Mark? Tell Mark the next time he's going to get up here and insult me about my fucking Run Happy hats. Mark doesn't like my Run Happy ads. I paid for all those sons of bitches. And if he wants to know why he watches TVG, it's because people like me advertise. Secondly, Mark wanted to whine about how much money he lost on whoever it was, Rich Strike, Epicenter, whoever the hell it was. I lost $3 million. I would like to meet Don Pierce before I leave. My favorite line ever about horse racing. Once upon a time, there was a horse named Kelso, but only once. I'm honored to be here tonight. I had a big, long speech written, but all you had to do to know how important PDJF was walking here tonight and see the jockeys in the wheelchairs. That tells the entire story. My thinking is horse racing has gone from number one in the American sports scene to close to last because of things they do that aren't up to date. I think horse racing needs to be totally transparent. But I think more than that, that horse racing needs to protect the jockeys and the horses by getting rid of all the drugs in the game and making it to where people can be safe, most especially the jockeys. I think the jockeys also need to have in every state, a health insurance plan, a disability plan, and a workers' comp plan. I think every horse that enters needs to pay a $50 entry fee, and that money goes to help the jockey's health insurance, disability, workers' comp. I think that ought to be $100 in any stakes race. And I think those type of things can fund the wonderful people who make this game possible, the jockeys. And also on the drug side, that is ruining the game. You don't know what type of horse you were betting on or betting against that beat you in a race. And all drugs need to be eliminated in horse racing and run it on the square. My final thought is this. If horse racing is going to succeed in the future, horse racing has to have superstars. Every sport has superstars. Some horse racing superstars I thought about, or horses that people would go watch, even if they weren't a horse racing fan, and jockeys that people would watch, even though they weren't a horse racing fan, like Lafitte Pincai, who's here tonight, Pat Day, Edgar Prado, and so many more. We need great jockeys. We need great horses like Kelso, Seabiscuit, Forgo, Zenyatta, Black Caviar, Frankel, Man of War, War Admiral, Citation, Secretariat, Farlap, Zenyatta, and of course, horses like John Henry and Forgo. Run Happy is a good one, too. Horse racing is a great game. Horse racing needs to get in the game. Horse racing needs to get to where some chump like me can bet $1 million and not move the line from 10 to 1 to 1 to 10. That's what horse racing needs to do. Horse racing needs to get out there and let young people be there. The man at my table is from Canterbury Downs. I understand they put on a great fan experience. That horse racing needs to be like the Savannah Bananas, where everybody wants to go because it's fun and it's entertaining and it's exciting. Horse racing is a great game, but it needs to get into the 21st century and make it a great game for everybody and keep the jockeys and keep the horses protected at all times because those are the main participants in the sport. Make superstars out of the horses, superstars out of the jockeys, and horse racing will undergo a 21st century revival. Y'all don't want to listen to me talk, so I'm done. Thank you.
Beautiful. I like the Savannah Bananas reference. Mattress Mac, that was chef's kiss. All right, without further ado, to move this along, we have Sandy Holly is going to come up, as well as Lynn Eckhaus, and they are going to make our next announcement for the special guests that are here. So really quick one, and we'll move right along. Give a round of applause for Sandy.
Thank you. Well, I've followed some tough acts before in my life, but holy crap. That is a tough act to follow. And Mattress Mike, I just have to tell you one quick story. You're talking about Kelso and all those great horses. I had a lady ask me one time if I ever rode the Seabiscuit. I said, well, man, that was 1938, but... Anyways, it is a pleasure to have a couple of other special guests here, good friends of my wife and crew. And first, I would like to introduce a gentleman. His name is Charles Malik Whitfield. Malik was born in Bronx, New York. I love saying that, Bronx, New York. And he started his career as an actor in 1989. Malik starred in many series and movies, just too many for me to mention. Malik was known for his role as Otis Williams in the miniseries The Temptations, and is currently teaching students, and he's producing and directing. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Charles Malik Whitfield. Thanks for being here, Charles. This next gentleman is an old friend of mine. He came to this event, we invited him, and he was supposed to go and play in the pickleball tournament, but it got canceled somehow, and he made it here. His name is Vince Van Patten. Yeah. Honest to goodness, I hadn't seen Vince for 40 years. I haven't seen Vince for 40 years. He hasn't changed at all, man. He's unbelievable. Vince was born in Belrose, New York. And he once told me that him and his dad, who was a good friend of mine as well, Mr. Dick Van Patten, when they were traveling from New York to California, Mr. Van Patten had to stop at every racetrack along the way and just check it out. That's the kind of horse racing fan he is, and Vince is the same way. Of course, Vince Van Patten was an actor. He was a tennis pro, ranked 25th in the world. I had to play against this guy one time. He invited me to his house, and Mr. Van Patten invited me as well, so I went to his house to play tennis, and lo and behold, I didn't realize my partner is Mr. Van Patten. His partner was Farrah Fawcett. I had the worst game of my life. I couldn't concentrate at the net at all. And actually, Vince actually beat John McEnroe twice. Is that any good or what? And now, he's the voice of the World Poker Tour, and I see him all the time, and I haven't seen him for 40 years. Ladies and gentlemen, Vince Van Patten. So I'm going to make it quick, too, Mattress Mike. Charles and Malik, I'd like to thank you so much for being here. I mean, supporting Jockeys and Jeans and PDJF is absolutely tremendous. We love having you guys here, and hopefully you can join us in the years to come. And you guys are great friends, and it's just wonderful to have you here. Thank you very much.
Hi, I'm Lynn Eckhaus, and I can't get up on the stage physically. It's a little problem. So if you don't mind, I'll stand here. I'm proud to be able to introduce two local entertainers, wonderful, wonderful people, friends of mine. One is Clint Holmes. Clint, 50 years ago, today, I think, was it today? 50 years ago today, a song that Clint sang as a very young man became number two. Well, it went up, it was released, nothing happened, and then all of a sudden it exploded. And it went up to number two on the pop charts. They sold 2.5 million records. It's amazing. Clint has done so many things over the years. He's an icon here in town. Everybody loves Clint. When Clint gets up on the stage, magic happens. It just, it's impossible to explain. You all should come see Clint. Clint's done so many things in his career. When Joan Rivers had her night show, Clint was her announcer. Clint had his own nighttime talk show in New York City and won a local Emmy with it. Clint has recently received 2 Grammy nominations, and he appears here at the Smith Center all the time. He's just a wonderful, wonderful performer. He's married to a wonderful performer, Kelly Clinton Holmes. She is, in her own rights, a wonderful singer, a great comedian, and together they make quite a couple. Clint, Kelly. Now I want to introduce another good friend of mine, local here, Giada Valenti. She's a wonderful singer. She was born in Venice, Italy. She has appeared in Carnegie Hall. She has had a PBS special that she starred in that was seen all over the country. She appears here at the Smith Center, and she's going to sing for us tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming singer and songwriter Giada Valenti. Born and raised in Venice, Italy, Giada has captivated audiences all over the world, performing on some of the most prestigious stages, such as Carnegie Hall in New York and the Smith Center for the Performing Arts in Las Vegas. She took America by storm with her spectacular national PBS special, From Venice with Love, and has also wowed European audiences with her talent. After participating last year in the popular television show, Holland Got Talent, she impressed the judges enough to earn a record deal. Giada is not just a musician, but also a passionate advocate for deaf awareness, supporting the cause in all her activities. She has lent her voice to many humanitarian efforts, including performing alongside Andrea Bocelli in support of his foundation, which is committed to empowering people and communities suffering from disease, poverty, and social exclusion. Giada Valenti not only enchants audiences with her singing and songwriting, but she also showcases her culinary expertise. She has shared her family recipes and her famous Venetian tiramisu dessert on numerous exclusive events and TV shows across the country, where she has become a favorite guest. Her charming and charismatic personality has also led her to become a recurrent performer and a co-host of the annual Columbus Day Parade in New York for ABC Television. Giada speaks in 5 languages fluently, and her angelic voice and lively personality has made audiences all over the world laugh, cry, and sing along with her. So, without further ado, let's welcome to the stage the multi-talented and charming Miss Giada Valenti!
Something in the way he moves attracts me like no other lover. Something in the way he woos me, I don't want to leave him now. You know I believe in how. Somewhere in his smile he knows that I don't need no other lover. Something in his style that shows me I don't want to leave it now. You know I believe in how. You're asking me, will my love grow? I don't know. something in the way he moves, and all I have to do is think of him. Something in the things he shows me. I don't want to leave it now. You know I believe and have. Buonasera, signore e signori. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Buenas noches. Hombres and caballeros. No, what is this? Hombres and damas or whatever, ladies and gentlemen. I am so happy to be here. Well, I was supposed to sing, I think, half an hour ago. But this has been such an amazing event. I want to start right away with my thank you. And then I will tell you what is my, as an Italian lady, connections with the Jockeys and the Kentucky Derby. You won't believe it. There's no coincidence. But anyway, I want to thank Len Eichhaus for inviting me to be here. Barry for inviting me to be here. It's been the most joyful experience. I was here last night, and tonight, of course, I met so many heroes, little giants. And you guys have been such an amazing experience for me. First of all, I have to tell you, being Italian, I don't know if you can see from the stage, but they always call me the little one, until I met you. And I said today, I know, I met many of the Jockeys in the Hall of Fame, Fantini, as we call it in Italy, and you guys have been amazing. I mean, you're amazing up there when you do those crazy things. I said, I'm afraid to fall from my shoes. And you're not afraid to fall from those horses while you're going 100 miles an hour. And you fall down, you break every bone in your body, and you go back again. I met some of you in the wheelchair, and I mean, you guys are amazing. So I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart. All of you, and also the Hall of Fame for honoring the one that probably would have had the same Hall of Fame careers, but something happened. They were not as fortunate as all of you, and still you didn't forget them. So me, as an Italian girl born and raised in Venice, when I moved to the United States in 2006, I didn't know nothing about the Kentucky Derby. I didn't know nothing about nothing of life. And then I think 5 years ago, I lived in New York City for 11 years, and somebody called me and he said, there is a little performance for you to do in Pennsylvania. Would you like to come? I said, sure. I got there and said, any requests for songs? I said, well, do you know any Kentucky song? I said, surely I do not. I do love country music and I do love Dolly Parton and all those things, but I said, I do not know Kentucky music. I said, well, they asked me to sing old Kentucky home, so I've learned it. And you're all familiar with that. And I didn't know I was singing for one of the congressmen of Kentucky, Hal Rogers. And of course, being Italian, I sang my whole Kentucky home, and then I sang a bunch of Italian songs like I will be doing tonight for you, because we are at Caesar Palace. It's like being at the capital of Italy, like being in Rome, and I have to be, this is home for me. So, but anyway, I sing all the song, and congressman from Kentucky, Hal Rogers, fell in love with me. What is the reason? Because I sang one song that was actually his wedding song. So the year later, he invited me to Kentucky to perform in his house. And then, of course, I met a lot of people from the Kentucky Derby. My luck. He said, next year, we will invite you to sing Run for the Roses. If you learn the song, I said, sure, I will learn the song, and you're coming to Kentucky. And the pandemic happened. So you got where I'm going. I had my hat, my dress, and I was ready to go to Kentucky. But Mr. Hal Rogers, he said, we are still doing so. I did this in a similar event, a little room in Kentucky. So I went to Lexington, Kentucky, and I've learned all the song, Run for the Roses, my whole Kentucky homes, and all those country music he wanted me to do. And so to be here tonight, when Len Eichhaus said, would you mind to come to Caesar Palace, of course, I'm there, to do what? And then he said to sing for the Jockeys and Jeans, and he told me what it was, and I was like, is it my destiny? I never met a Jockeys before, but now, I mean, I'm here tonight, and I think I met everybody that was part of the Kentucky Derby and means anything and everything to the Kentucky Derby. So thank you, Barry. This has been amazing that you let me come here. And by the way, May 4 next year, I'm free. If somebody wants to invite me at the Kentucky Derby, head is ready. So tonight, as I mentioned, I talk too much. And I do it in five languages. That's a problem. And
I mean, I met before Michael and Gabby, and I promised Gabby that I will do some sign language for her. So she knows that she's beautiful already, and I'm very happy to be here tonight and to meet you guys. I don't know where Gabby is sitting, but Gabby is deaf, and Gabby, you are beautiful. So anyway, yes, an applause for Gabby. I hope, Michael, you're translating all my talk to her. So I want to sing a bunch of Italian songs tonight, as I do in all my concerts. And you will say, we do not speak Italian. You don't need to speak Italian, because I'm very proud, always proud to say, whatever concert I do, that there are so many songs that have a little bit of Italian on it. I start with Something, written by George Harris. There is nothing Italian in there, but it was Frank Sinatra's favorite love songs. So we needed to sing that song. And this one that I'm singing you, I'm very proud because I started to perform it many years ago when I moved to the United States. Listen to this. It's a song that you will love from the first note. It was written by an Italian, a Neapolitan guy called Salvatore Guaragna. In 1900, he left Naples, went to Ellis Island, New York, and he went to live in Brooklyn. He was a young kid, 19, 20 years old, and he wanted to be a songwriter. And somebody said to him, with that song, with that name, Salvatore Guaragna, you're going no place. At the time, being in Italian was very difficult. So he decided to Americanize his name. He became Harry Warren. With the name of Harry Warren, he has written some of the most beautiful songs of the American songbooks. Just to mention a few that you may know. He wrote The More I See You. He wrote When the moon hits your eye like a bigger pizza pie, that's amore. He wrote also, I only advise for you, for Ella Fitzgerald. Not only that, he wrote also the music for the musical on Broadway, 42nd Street. He was nominated 11 times for Best Song from the movie at the Oscars. So I'm very proud to sing tonight for all of you my favorite song of Harry Warren, of, as I love to remember him, Salvatore Guaragna. Here's the song. At last, my love has come along. My lonely days are over, and life is like a song. Oh, at last, the skies above are blue. My heart was wrapped up in clover. The night I looked at you, I found a dream that I could speak to. A dream that I can call my own. I found a thrill I can rest my cheek to. A thrill that I have never known. Hey, when you smile, when you smile, the spell was cast, and here we are in heaven. For you are mine at last. Woo! Salvatore Guaragna. Grazie. Grazie. Normally, I always ask, how many, any Italian in the room? Ci sono italiani? Say yes. Wow. Anybody in the room that is not Italian but would love to be one? It's always like that. It's always like that. So I'm going to sing a song now, actually, and I will be able to step down and they're not here as Caesar, they said. I can come down to the first table. But actually, this is a song that is the song I sang for Congressman Al Rogers when I met him the first. And believe it or not, he sang along with me. It's an Italian song. It's like an Italian anthem. It's about a dream that came true for probably every jockey's a year. I talked with some of you, and all of you started as young kid. Actually, one of you told me, I was feeding a horse, I was 12, and I said, oh, I love horses. And before he knew, he became a jockey. I met the other one, where is Tony Black? Tony Black, the smallest giants I've ever met. I have so many laughs with him. And he said, if you're coming down the stage, I'm gonna be doing the walk moon with you. But anyway, it's a dream that came true. When I was a little girl, I had this dream that I wanted to be a singer. I never had a dream that I wanted to go to the Kentucky Derby or sing for the jockeys, for the Fantini. Now I do have that dream. And who knows, maybe that dream is coming up too. So it's a song that I've been singing. I've been lucky to sing all over the world, in Europe, everywhere. And it's a magical song, because even though if you don't speak Italian, I know at a certain point I will be doing like this. And magically... By the way, I can see nothing because I have so much lights on me. I don't even know if you are there. So when I do like this, you're going to be singing in perfect Italian. Can you believe that? And so I'm going to start. And when I'm doing, you're going to be singing. Is that a deal? You want to warm up your voice or you're all professional? All professional, of course. So I'm going to start. This is a song. And let's see if you guys are a great audience. I'm sure you are. I started and I'm coming down.
Penso che un sogno così non ritorni mai più. Mi dipingevo le mani e la faccia di blu. Poi d'improvviso venivo dal vento rapita. E cominciavo a volare nel cielo infinito. Ready?
Ready?
Volare. Cantare. Oh,
there you are.
Nel blu, dipinto di blu. Felice di stare lassù, ma tutti I sogni nell'alba svaniscono perché quando tramonta la luna li porta con sé. Ma io continuo a sognare negli occhi tuoi belli. Che sono blu come un cielo trapunto di stelle.
Now this part of the room.
Volare all along. Cantare. Oh.
Oh, Persia.
Nel blu dipinto di blu. Felice di stare lassù. E volavo, volavo felice, più in alto del sole ed ancora più su. Mentre il mondo spariva pian piano negli occhi tuoi blu.
Is the one?
Una musica dolce suonava soltanto per me.
Here we go. Better.
Cantare.
I'm there.
Nel blu, dipinto di blu. Felice di stare lassù. Nel blu, dipinto di blu.
voce di stare lassù. So happy that I was here tonight with all of you. And you look so beautiful for close and personal. Thank you so very much. You were scared of me. What is your name, sir?
You don't know me very well.
I don't know you very well. Now I'm scared of you. Oh my gosh. He said, you don't know me very well. But I saw Clint, he was a little bit shy. Anyway, so I'm going to leave you with one last song. I'm going on stage because that gentleman scared him. What's your name, sir? Paul. Judge Paul. So if I get in trouble, can I get to call you? Where are you based? In Kentucky? Florida? Can you cover all the states? Can I be in trouble in any kind of states in the United States? Also abroad? I'm going to Europe next Monday. Can you give me your card? Take care of me. I want to thank also all the high roller or people that tonight bid for all those items, because this has been an applause for all of you. And to the gentleman that was amazing. He didn't have a sip of water and he spoke for 45 minutes like... That's what I got from it. My English is very bad. Actually, I do speak five languages and English is my fourth one in the... So, yeah. So the other one I'm much better. But hey, they told me there was also a lot of Spanish people, and I got to meet a lot of you. I have this passion and love also for Spanish music. So I'm sorry that I'm not singing tonight any Spanish song. So you have to come to one of my concerts to have it. Or invite me next time, Barry. And we're going to do My Whole Kentucky Home and some Latino song. I know one of my favorites is Bésame, bésame mucho, como si fuera esta noche la última vez. Actually, that's one of the songs that I did with Andrea Bocelli. But one of the songs that Andrea always asked me to sing, and I'm very, very happy because it's the song that made me a singer. When I was a little girl in Venice, Italy, where I was born and raised, I've learned this song. I was only 4 years old. My grandmother's best friend happened to be Severine. She was French. And she started to play the music of this singer. And somehow, as a little girl, this is the song that resonated with me the most. I was four. I was already singing the song. Later in life, I wanted to learn the language. The song is in French. I wanted to learn the language because I wanted to know what the song was about. So I'm going to leave you tonight with the song that made me a singer. I hope you're going to enjoy it. And by the way, we are in the House of Caesars. I also want to thank Caesar Palace for hosting us tonight and for their generosity with that $30,000. I don't know if they're still here, but it's kind of impressive. So this is the song. And if you don't speak French, I don't know if there are French-speaking people in this room, the lyrics are very simple and very, very powerful. And JJ can already start the music. I'm basically singing, when he embraced me and he speaks to me softly words of love, my life is beautiful. I'm his and he is mine. That's the reason why my heart beats. I wish you love, and I leave you with my favorite song, La Vie en Rose, which means life is beautiful. And I really hope life is going to be beautiful for each and every one of us, and especially for our heroes. My little giants, I love you guys, each and every one of you. Deux yeux qui font baisser les miennes, un rire que se perce sa bouche. Voilà le portrait sans retouche de l'homme auquel j'appartiens. Quand il
me prend dans ses bras, il me parle tout bas, je vois la vie en rose. Il me dit des mots d'amour, des mots de tous les jours, et ça me fait quelque chose. Il est entré dans mon cœur, une part de bonheur dont je connais la cause. C'est lui pour moi, moi pour lui dans la vie. Il met la vie, la journée pour la vie. Dès que je l'aperçois, alors je sens en moi mon cœur qui bat. Ra 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 ra. La vie en rose. La ra 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 ra. La vie en rose. Il est entré dans mon cœur, une part de bonheur dont je connais la cause. C'est lui pour moi, moi pour lui dans la vie. Il met la vie, la journée pour la vie. Et dès que je l'aperçois, alors je sens en moi mon cœur qui bat. La 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 la.
Thank you very much. Muchas gracias. Thank you very much. God bless you all. Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Gosh, wasn't she wonderful? The Italian, the French. It's all so lovely and sensual. She was great. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to go on with some more entertainment. And I already introduced him, and you guys got 45 minutes, she said, of him talking. So let's hear him talk some more, ladies and gentlemen. Everyone, welcome Mark Klein up to the stage.
Well, thank you all so much. This will be short and sweet, like most of the people here tonight. My name's Mark Klein. I'm from Louisville, Kentucky. And when I travel, people always ask me, Mark, besides horses, what does Kentucky have? And I tell them, here's what we make in Kentucky. We make bourbon. We make baseball bats. We make cigarettes. We make fried chicken. Our state motto is, if it kills you, we make it. And I love sharing things about Kentucky with the audiences that I'm in front of. I fell in love with horse racing, of course, being from Louisville, and a little bit of history of that. In 1969, the two-year-old racing champion in America was a colt named My Dad George. They sent My Dad George to Florida for his training and brought him back to Louisville at age three. He won the Florida Derby at three and the Fountain of Youth, and they bring him to Louisville. He's now the post-time favorite for the 1970 Kentucky Derby, and he is the two-year-old champion, the best racehorse in North America. It's 1970. I'm 16 years old. The horse's name is My Dad George, and my father's name is George. And I took this as a sign from God. It was my fate to be a racetrack gambling millionaire. Every dollar I made raking leaves, cutting grass, shoveling snow, took to Churchill Downs Racetrack in May of 1970, put it on my dad George, win a 1970 Kentucky Derby. Anybody here know how that race turned out? Mike Manganella, riding Dust Commander, waxed him like a bikini line. He loses by daylight. 2 weeks later, he starts the Preakness as the favorite. I borrow money to bet this horse. He loses that race by a neck. 3 weeks later, starts his Belmont as the favorite. I borrow more money to bet this horse. He loses that race. Only two horses have ever done that, start Triple Crown events as a favorite and lose them all. The other was in 1985, a horse named Chief's Crown. My dad George did it in 1970. I bet on him every time. They retired him to stud duty after that, and he lived to be 26 years old. He's buried at a horse farm in Kentucky, and I've been to see his grave because he still owes me $7,000. So he wasn't much of a hero to be, but my father was my life's hero. My dad, I just adored the man. He passed away 5 years ago at age 93, a grand and glorious man. He was my hero for so many reasons. I'll tell you a story about that. My mom and dad were married for 48 years when she died, and she predeceased him by 25 years. So naturally, my dad went into mourning, went into a period of depression. Then he made a choice. He made a conscious choice, a touching choice, a human and heroic choice. He chose to live again. He chose to be alive again. Her book of life was closed. His book of life was open. It started going out again. Now, I can tell you folks something. Women loved my dad. Women absolutely loved my dad. Every week, there were five or six ladies. They were all 85 years old. They would call him. Let's go get supper. Let's go see a show. Let's go see a movie. I say, Pop, what's the appeal? What's making these women so crazy for you? He said, I drive at night. My dad had fun every day. His life, his goal in life, this amazing man, his goal in life was to make sure you had a smile on your face too. When he was 80 years old, I took him to a Waffle House restaurant for breakfast one morning. Now, I'll tell you about my dad at 80. He had no fear. He had no filter. And that means he would flirt with any woman in the world. The waitress brings him coffee. She goes, sir, how do you like your coffee? My dad thought he'd be cute. He said, I like my coffee like I like my women. She said, I'm sorry, sir, we don't serve 85-year-old coffee. So he starts dating at 80, and he said, son, I need a new wardrobe. I'm going out with women again. He wants a wardrobe at 80. Who can argue with that? I said, okay, Pop. He said, son, take me to Kohl's department store. Do they have Kohl's here in Las Vegas? My father loved Kohl's. They would send him coupons in the mail called Kohl's Cash. He used it to tip with. That's my dad. He's an amazing human being. When he turned 90, he knew that he couldn't live alone anymore, so he took his car out for the last time and found a place to live. Didn't take his kids with him, went by himself. That's the kind of man he was. He ends up at a place called Magnolia Springs. It's a cruise ship on land for old people. And my dad became mayor of that joint in about 3 weeks. He set up a poker game for other 85 and 90-year-old men and women, and to watch this game was a test of the soul. Because the man who couldn't see would deal. And the woman who couldn't hear would make change. And what they played for 45 minutes every Friday night was a 7-card stud variant of poker called Little Red Hen. You ever hear of it? Nope, because they made it up. Here's an approximation of the rules. 7-card stud poker, 2 cards face down, 4 cards face up, last card face down. The lowest card face down that is red is wild. If it matches a card that is like it, that is face up, that is black. Those are the rules. These men didn't remember what they had for breakfast that morning, and those are the rules. But I adored the man. He taught me everything in life worth knowing I learned from my father. He said, son, travel. You are changed in life by the places you go and the people you meet. And that's true very much of events just like this tonight. You're changed in life by the places you go and the people you meet. That's why I love to travel. He said, let the world amaze you because it will. And there's no greater city for that than Las Vegas, Nevada. What an amazing city this is. The strangest things happen to you in Las Vegas. I'm walking down the street. They have one of these beautiful women on the street dressed as showgirls that come up to you. And as I walk by, she says, I like your tie. I said, excuse me, She said, I like your tie. I said, are you flirting with me? She said, yes, I am. I said, young lady, I'm a 60-year-old man from Louisville, Kentucky. You want to get my full attention? Do not discuss my tie. You want to get my full attention? Give me a $3 off coupon for Metamucil. Now you have my attention. She said, I work at this club behind me. Come see my show. I said, look, I'm sure it's a great show. I'd love to see it. You're wearing less cotton than what they put in the top of an aspirin bottle. I'm sure it's a great show. But I have to work myself tonight. She goes, what time do you get off? I said, I get done at 2 o'clock in the morning. She goes, I get done at 2 o'clock in the morning. Come back at 2:15, take me to breakfast. Then we'll go to a private club I can get us into because I'm a member there. I said, slow down, young lady. Number one, you're half my age. We're not going to have a lot to talk about. Number two, at 2 o'clock in the morning, I'll be a little tired. I'm out here on Eastern Standard Time. You're on Mountain West Time. At 2 a.m., I'll be pleasuring myself to Antiques Roadshow and going to bed. That's a big night for me. But number three, most importantly, I'm a married man. I probably should not do something like that. And then she says, well, how married are you? Really? How married am I? Well, let me think. I'm flat broke and I'm always wrong. You tell me. I am a married man. I got married. I was 38 years old, happy and single for 38 years. I finally met that one woman who said those six words I waited all of my life to hear. My dad owns a liquor store, is what she said. Say how I met my wife. This is a true story. I did a comedy show in a nightclub in Savannah, Georgia. She sat in the front row. She didn't laugh at a word I said. I thought to myself, if she can't make you miserable, nobody can. So I stop her walking out. We start to talk. Here's why she didn't laugh. As it turns out, we're opposites. We are polar opposites, any topic you care to name. We're an interracial couple. Yes, we are. I'm from Kentucky, and she's not a relative. We're opposites. Any topic you want to name. Physically, we're opposite. You all see me up here. I'm 5 feet, 4.5 inches tall. So I weigh 151 pounds. I'm built real short, and I'm kind of squatty. My wife is a 125-pound, 5 foot, 10-inch tall, green-eyed redhead. She towers over me as the angel of death. And I said one time, honey, does it ever bother you how much shorter I am than you are? She said, only when you can't go on the rides with me at the fair. Now, she's brutally honest, which is one of the many things I love about her. She's an honest woman, not even to a fault. She just tells the truth all the time. When we first met, she's looking down on me. She goes, well, there's not much to you, is there, Mr. Klein? And I said, I'm a lot taller when I stand on my checkbook. Oh, yeah. About our third date, she finally asked me, why didn't my height intimidate you? Well, you think on your feet. I said, well, if your great beauty did not shoo me off, what makes you think your height would? She said, keep talking, Shorty, you're almost home. But I will tell you this, I've been married for 30 years. My wife walks in the room, my heart still skips a beat. That is true. You call it love, you call it fear. Doesn't much matter to me, I don't care. But we're opposites. We're opposites. Only in humans do opposites attract. No other animal has that happen. Only in humans do opposites attract. And a couple things make that possible. Number one, we communicate. We over-communicate. We under-communicate. We communicate. One of life's great lessons taught to me by my father, sometimes knowing when to stop communicating is every bit as important as knowing when to start. An example. Every man sitting in this room tonight at one point in his life has looked into the eyes of a woman he clearly adores. And with a straight face and sincere heart, he has asked of her the following question. Honey, are you mad? And gentlemen, I can sure as shooting promise you, if you have to ask, she's mad. My dad said, telling you reach that point, shut up. I said, why? He said, here's why. You're in a fight, you don't know it, and you've lost. Communications partner in life. A lesson we learn as we get older is compromise. We learn how to compromise. I'll give you an example. I never had a dog as a kid. Mrs. Klein had a dog all of her life, so we compromised, and we got a dog. Now, we didn't go to the pet store in the shopping mall to get a purebred dog. Somebody with money will buy and take care of that little dog. We had to go to the animal shelter to get a little stray dog that nobody else wanted. When we got it home, I found out why no one else wanted this dog. The first fight we ever had, where is the dog going to sleep? I'm very old-fashioned. Here's what I believe. I believe if you have fur and four legs, you sleep in the backyard. That's my theory. If you think that lasted 5 minutes, you missed it by 4 minutes and 58 seconds. I went to Walmart. I bought a doggy bed. I bought a $47 cedar chip-filled fleece-lined bed for a dog. My own mattress, by the way, cost $29.95. I did get it for Mattress Mac, of course, so there you have it. I said, honey, we'll compromise. A dog can sleep in the basement in the doggy bed. Wrong. Second compromise. All right, honey, it's February. It's cold outside. The dog can sleep in the kitchen next to the stove where it's warm in the doggy bed. Wrong. Third compromise, and I about had it. Okay, honey, they all can sleep in our bedroom next to our people bed in its doggy bed. Compromise number four. The dog is not allowed underneath the covers. This is where we currently stand. When I get up at night to go to the bathroom, the dog has to take her nose out of my ass. That's where we stand now. Compromise. All I'm telling you folks is it's 1 o'clock in the morning, I have a tongue stuck in each ear, and I can't tell them apart. One nose is warm, one nose is cold. They both need a pedicure. Mustache is about the same, but that's not the point. I tell these stories, and I share them with my wife, and she says, you know, you ought to tell about the things you have passion for, so I will. I'll tell you a story about the great horse Northern Dancer. Everyone here knows who Northern Dancer was. The only Canadian bred colt ever to win the Kentucky Derby. He was a tough little guy. He was a lot like jockeys. He was tough, kind of underrated, but as tough as nails, just a kind of a reddish-brown colt. He broke his maiden at Fort Erie Racetrack near Buffalo, and he comes to his Kentucky Derby. He wasn't the Derby favorite. He went off at 7-2 odds, but he won his race. He won his Preakness 2 weeks later, almost won his Belmont. He was almost a Triple Crown champion. They retire Northern Dancer to stud duty at age 4, and they bring him to his first broodmare. Now, they get this old, he got about a 12-year-old broodmare they bring him to, and she's already dropped a couple foals, but he's never done this before. And they bring him in, they have her all teased up, and he sees his date for the night, and he's glad to see her. Visibly glad to see her. You know, they could see from Apollo 6 how glad he was to see her. It didn't do him any good, because when he got up to fulfill his breeding contract, it turns out he was just too short. He was about a foot and a half short of being able to fill out his contract to do what he's being paid to do. Well, as you all know, in Kentucky, a breeding contract's a sacred document, so they got to figure this out, and they do. They bring Dancer back to her the next day, and they get her all teased up again, and they've dug an 18-inch deep ditch for her to stand in. And this brood mare is up 18 inches deep in this ditch, and Northern Dancer walks in, and you don't have to show him again. He gets up and does, he's being paid a lot of money to do, and he becomes, as you know, the most successful stud in North America for 25 years, including Frank Sinatra and John Travolta. So I love telling that story, because as you may recall earlier in my show, I am 5'4.5" tall, and my wife is 5'10" tall. And I will tell you, she did not much care for that ditch the first time she saw it, but things have a way of working out, and you work things out okay. I teach my son that. Got a 26-year-old son. He's a newlywed. He and his wife got married 2 years ago, and they are physical with one another as only newlyweds can be. They hold hands, they hug, they kiss, they touch. God knows what else. They are so enamored of one another that they cannot stand to be out of physical contact for as long as a minute. And God bless him, he thinks this will last forever. I said, son, nothing lasts forever. Enjoy this. Enjoy what you can, where you can, how you can. Enjoy it all. Be aware all things come to an end. Two can't stand any bit apart for a minute right now. One day, be married 30 years like I've been. You want to have sex? She'll have to be in something that they call the mood. And the mood is a passing and whimsical thing. Look, there it is. No, it's gone. And if you were trying to put her in the mood when she is not already in the mood, then, my son, you are a blind man in a dark room looking for a black cat that is not there. But you got to laugh at it. You got to laugh at it all because you can. You're the only animal in the history of life in the universe that can laugh. So you should laugh every day. It's good for you. Releases all the chemicals in your brain that help, none of the ones that hurt. Only animal tells jokes. The only animal responds to jokes told to us. We're designed to survive through laughter. So I close all the shows I do with old-fashioned jokes. Jokes I didn't write, jokes I heard from people just like yourselves. Want to tell me your favorite joke? I'd love to hear it because I love to hear jokes. I'll tell you some of my family's favorite jokes. Before we get to that, I have an award to give out, and the recipient knows nothing about this, which is rather unusual. It's called the Life's Philosophy Award. One of my philosophy in life is to pursue your dreams. And to be a comedian was always a life's dream of mine. I had a job earlier. I tried boxing for a year and a half. I wasn't very good. In 1974, I was Kentucky's most requested opponent. That didn't work out. But my philosophy is pursue your dreams, and it requires putting your head down and going straight ahead. And the recipient of this award is Mrs. Nancy LaSala. Nancy, can you come up here real quickly? Nancy, I have something for you that you don't know anything about, but I'd like to offer this to you. Nancy, are you out there, dear? Oh, she's at registration. Well, if someone could give this to her, it's an award that I prepared for. It's her life's philosophy on a bumper sticker. It says, grant others the wisdom to let me control them. It's about pursuing dreams. You know, I pursued a dream this year. I bought a thoroughbred racehorse, and it was so cool. They didn't tell me, if you own it, you get to name your horse. And, of course, the great tradition is you combine the sire's name and the dam's name, the horse's mother and father. So, like I said, well, give me an example. They said Ali Sheba from his sire Alidar and his dam Belsheba. They named the colt Ali Sheba. So we did that. We used a stallion named Prickly Ruler and a brood mare named Constant Complaint. We named it Barry Pearl. That did okay, I think that. I've gotten to know so many of my heroes at this event, Barry, of course, being one of them. I didn't realize he looks like he's about 55 years old. I asked somebody, how old is he? They said he was taken off of Man of War because the trainer wanted a younger jockey. So I just had no idea. He looks like a million bucks, as all the heroes that I met at this event. So we share each other's jokes and stories. Tell your jokes. Tell your stories. My family's favorite jokes, short and sweet. Here they are. My brother's a doctor. Here's his favorite joke. Man goes to a psychiatrist. Doctor, can you help me? He says, what's wrong? He said, I think I'm a dog. You what? I think I'm a dog. I bark at the moon. I roll on the ground. I tell you, doc, I think I'm a dog. Can you help me? Well, I don't know. Get on the couch and we'll talk about it. No, I'm not allowed on the couch. My sister's favorite joke. A man runs to a hospital. I did something terrible. Somebody help me. Sir, what did you do? I accidentally squalled the tiles to my Scrabble set. You what? I accidentally squalled the tiles to my Scrabble set. What do I do? Well, be careful in the bathroom. It could spell disaster. My mother-in-law's favorite joke. A man takes three women to his mother's house for lunch one day. They have lunch and they go home. He goes, Mama, what'd you think of the girls? She said, they're beautiful girls. He said, Mom, I'm going to marry one of them. She goes, I know. You're going to marry the tall redhead, the one in the middle. He said, that's right. How did you know that? She goes, I didn't like her. My father-in-law's favorite joke. Older couple driving on the highway. The husband's driving. The wife is hard of hearing. She's kind of deaf. He's behind the wheel. He checks his rearview mirror. Sees a flashing blue police light. Pulls his car to the side of the road. Cop walks up. Let me see your license. She said, what did he say? He says, he wants to see my license, honey, and he hands it up. Policeman goes, says he live in Louisville, Kentucky. She said, what did he say? He says, you live in Louisville, dear. The cop laughs. I'm going to tell you a funny story. The worst sex I ever had in my life was with a woman from Louisville, Kentucky. She said, what did he say? He said he thinks he knows you. It's my family's favorite jokes. We have time for one more? I'm sorry? One more. Actually, I tell you something more important than a joke. All these jokes that I tell at the end of the show, my family members told me. When you hear a joke from someone you love, you will hear that joke for the rest of your life in their voice. So when I tell you a joke that my dad or my uncle told me, you hear it through the microphone in my voice. I hear it as clearly as though they were standing here next to me tonight. So learn your family stories, tell your family stories, share your family's jokes with your family, and I can promise you this. When your children tell their children your stories, they will hear their stories in your voice. And no matter what has become of you, you will be with them still. Thank you all for being with us tonight. Thanks for coming out. Good night.
All right, guys, that was a long night, but a wonderful one. I think we made a lot of money, and it was a big success. I'm so excited that I got to be here with you guys. Give all of our riders a round of applause, and everyone who donated as well, thank you so much. And to Nancy and Barry, and the entire team, you guys really kill it every year with these events. So thank you so much for all your hard work. And thank everyone, all of you guys, for donating, which is the most important part, to support our permanently disabled jockeys. Have a good night!